Book of Numbers, Chapter 1. The Lord spoke to Moses in the wilderness of Sinai, in the tent of meeting, on the first day of the second month, in the second year after they had come out of the land of Egypt, saying, Take a census of all the congregation of the children of Israel, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, every male, one by one, from 20 years old and upward, all who are able to go out to war in Israel. You and Aaron shall number them by their divisions. With you there shall be a man of every tribe, every one head of his father's house. These are the names of the men who shall stand with you: of Reuben, Elitzur the son of Shedeur; of Simeon, Shelumiel the son of Zurishaddai; of Judah, Nashon the son of Amminadab; of Issachar, Nethanel the son of Zur; of Zebulun, Eliab the son of Helon; of the children of Joseph, of Ephraim, Elishama the son of Ammihud; of Manasseh, Gamaliel the son of Pedazur; of Benjamin, Abidan the son of Gideoni; of Dan, Ahizer the son of Amishaddai; of Asher, Pagiel the son of Ochran; of Gad, Eliasaph the son of Ruel; of Naphtali, Aharah the son of Enon. These are those who were called of the congregation, the leaders of the tribes of their fathers. They were the heads of the thousands of Israel. Moses and Aaron took these men who are mentioned by name. They assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month, and they declared their ancestry by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, one by one. As the Lord commanded Moses, so he numbered them in the wilderness of Sinai. The children of Reuben, Israel's firstborn, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, one by one, every male from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Reuben, were 46,500. Of the children of Simeon, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, those who were numbered of it, according to the number of the names, one by one, every male from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Simeon, were 59,300. Of the children of Gad, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Gad, were 45,650. Of the children of Judah, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Judah, were 64,600. Of the children of Issachar, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Issachar, were 54,400. Of the children of Zebulun, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Zebulun, were 57,400. Of the children of Joseph, of the children of Ephraim, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Ephraim, were 40,500. Of the children of Manasseh, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Manasseh, were 32,200. Of the children of Benjamin, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Benjamin, were 35,400. Of the children of Dan, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go forth to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Dan, were 62,700. Of the children of Asher, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go forth to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Asher, were 41,500. Of the children of Naphtali, their generations, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of the names, from 20 years old and upward, All who were able to go forth to war, those who were numbered of them, of the tribe of Naphtali, were 53,400. These are those who were numbered, whom Moses and Aaron numbered, and the leaders of Israel, being 12 men, each representing his father's house. So all those who were numbered of the children of Israel by their father's houses, from 20 years old and upward, all who were able to go out to war in Israel, even all those who were numbered were 603,550. But the Levites after the tribe of their fathers were not numbered among them. For the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Only the tribe of Levi you shall not number, neither shall you take a census of them among the children of Israel, but appoint the Levites over the tabernacle of the testimony, and over all its furnishings, and over all that belongs to it. They shall carry the tabernacle, and all its furnishings, and they shall take care of it, and shall camp around it. When the tabernacle is to move, the Levites shall take it down, and when the tabernacle is to be set up, the Levites shall set it up. The unauthorized person who comes near shall be put to death. The children of Israel shall pitch their tents, every man by his own camp, and every man by his own standard, according to their divisions. But the Levites shall camp around the tabernacle of the testimony, that there may be no wrath on the congregation of the children of Israel, and the Levites shall be responsible for the tabernacle of the testimony." Thus the children of Israel did, according to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so they did. Chapter 2. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "The children of Israel shall camp every man by his own standard, with the banners of their fathers' houses, at a distance from the tent of meeting shall they camp around it. Those who camp on the east side toward the sunrise shall be of the standard of the camp of Judah, according to their divisions, and the prince of the children of Judah shall be Nashon the son of Amminadab. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 74,600. Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Issachar, and the prince of the children of Issachar shall be Nethanel the son of Zur. His division, and those who were numbered of it, were 54,400. The tribe of Zebulun, and the prince of the children of Zebulun shall be Eliab the son of Helon. His division, and those who were numbered of it, were 57,400. All who were numbered of the camp of Judah were 186,400, according to their divisions. They shall set out first. On the south side shall be the standard of the camp of Reuben according to their divisions. The prince of the children of Reuben shall be Elitzur the son of Shadur. His division, and those who were numbered of it, were 46,500. Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Simeon. The prince of the children of Simeon shall be Shelumiel the son of Zurishaddai. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 59,300. The tribe of Gad, and the prince of the children of Gad shall be Eliasaph the son of Reuel. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 45,650. All who were numbered of the camp of Reuben were 151,450, according to their armies. They shall set out second. Then the tent of meeting shall set out, with the camp of the Levites in the midst of the camps. As they camp, so shall they set out, every man in his place, by their standards. On the west side shall be the standard of the camp of Ephraim according to their divisions, and the prince of the children of Ephraim shall be Elishama the son of Ammihud. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 40,500. Next to him shall be the tribe of Manasseh, and the prince of the children of Manasseh shall be Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 32,200. The tribe of Benjamin, and the prince of the children of Benjamin shall be Abidan the son of Gideoni. His army, and those who were numbered of them, were 35,400. All who were numbered of the camp of Ephraim were 108,100, according to their divisions. They shall set out third. On the north side shall be the standard of the camp of Dan according to their divisions, and the prince of the children of Dan shall be Ahizur the son of Ammishaddai. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 62,700. Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Asher, and the prince of the children of Asher shall be Pagiel the son of Ochran. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 41,500. The tribe of Naphtali, and the prince of the children of Naphtali shall be Ahirah the son of Enon. His division, and those who were numbered of them, were 53,400. All who were numbered of the camp of Dan were 157,600. They shall set out last by their standards. These are those who were numbered of the children of Israel by their fathers' houses. All who were numbered of the camps according to their armies were 603,550. But the Levites were not numbered among the children of Israel, as the Lord commanded Moses. Thus the children of Israel did according to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so they camped by their standards, and so they set out, everyone by their families, according to their fathers' houses. Chapter 3. Now this is the history of the generations of Aaron and Moses in the day that the Lord spoke with Moses in Mount Sinai. These are the names of the sons of Aaron: Nadab the firstborn, and Abihu, Eleazar, and Ithamar. These are the names of the sons of Aaron, the priests who were anointed, whom he consecrated to minister in the priest's office. Nadab and Abihu died before the Lord, when they offered strange fire before the Lord, in the wilderness of Sinai, and they had no children. Eleazar and Ithamar ministered in the priest's office in the presence of Aaron their father. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Bring the tribe of Levi near, and set them before Aaron the priest, that they may minister to him. They shall keep his requirements, and the requirements of the whole congregation before the tent of meeting, to do the service of the tabernacle. They shall keep all the furnishings of the tent of meeting, and the obligations of the children of Israel, to do the service of the tabernacle. You shall give the Levites to Aaron and to his sons. They are wholly given to him on the behalf of the children of Israel. And you shall appoint Aaron and his sons, and they shall attend to their priesthood, but the unauthorized person who comes near shall be put to death." The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Look, I have taken the Levites from among the children of Israel instead of all the firstborn who open the womb among the children of Israel, and the Levites shall be mine, for all the firstborn are mine. On the day that I struck down all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, I made holy to me all the firstborn in Israel, both man and animal. They shall be mine. I am the Lord." The Lord spoke to Moses in the wilderness of Sinai, saying, "Count the children of Levi by their fathers' houses, by their families. You shall count every male from a month old and upward." Moses numbered them according to the word of the Lord, as he was commanded. These were the sons of Levi by their names: Gershon, and Kohath, and Merari. These are the names of the sons of Gershon by their families: Libni and Shimei. The sons of Kohath by their families: Amram, and Izhar, Hebron, and Uziel. The sons of Merari by their families: Mahli and Mushi. These are the families of the Levites according to their fathers' houses. Of Gershon was the family of the Libnites, and the family of the Shimites. These are the families of the Gershonites. Those who were numbered of them, according to the number of all the males, from a month old and upward, even those who were numbered of them were 7,500. The families of the Gershonites shall camp behind the tabernacle westward. The prince of the father's house of the Gershonites shall be Eliasaph the son of Lael. The duty of the sons of Gershon in the tent of meeting shall be the tabernacle, and the tent, its covering, and the screen for the door of the tent of meeting, and the curtaining of the court, and the screen for the door of the court, which is by the tabernacle, and around the altar, and its cords for all of its service. Of Kohath was the family of the Amramites, and the family of the Isharites, and the family of the Hebronites, and the family of the Uzielites. These are the families of the Kohathites. According to the number of all the males, from a month old and upward, there were 8,600, keeping the requirements of the sanctuary. The families of the sons of Kohath shall camp on the south side of the tabernacle. The prince of the father's house of the families of the Kohathites shall be Elizaphan the son of Uziel. Their duty shall be the ark, the table, the lampstand, the altars, the vessels of the sanctuary with which they minister, and the screen, and all its service. Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest shall be chief of the leaders of the Levites, with the oversight of those who keep the requirements of the sanctuary. Of Merari was the family of the Mahlites, and the family of the Mushites. These are the families of Merari. Those who were numbered of them, according to the number of all the males, from a month old and upward, were 6,200. The prince of the father's house of the families of Merari was Zeriel the son of Abihail. They shall camp on the north side of the tabernacle. The appointed duty of the sons of Merari shall be the tabernacle's boards, its bars, its pillars, its sockets, all its instruments, all its service, the pillars of the court around it, their sockets, their pins, and their cords. Those who camp before the tabernacle eastward, in front of the tent of meeting toward the sunrise, shall be Moses, and Aaron and his sons, keeping the requirements of the sanctuary for the duty of the children of Israel. The stranger who comes near shall be put to death. All who were numbered of the Levites, whom Moses and Aaron numbered at the commandment of the Lord, by their families, all the males from a month old and upward, were 22,000. The Lord said to Moses, "Number all the firstborn males of the children of Israel from a month old and upward, and take the number of their names. You shall take the Levites for me, I am the Lord, instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and the livestock of the Levites instead of all the firstborn among the livestock of the children of Israel." Moses numbered, as the Lord commanded him, all the firstborn among the children of Israel. All the firstborn males according to the number of names, from a month old and upward, of those who were numbered of them, were 22,273. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Take the Levites instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and the livestock of the Levites instead of their livestock, and the Levites shall be mine. I am the Lord." For the redemption of the 273 of the firstborn of the children of Israel, who exceed the number of the Levites, you shall take 5 shekels apiece for each one. After the shekel of the sanctuary you shall take them, the shekel is 20 gerahs, and you shall give the money, with which the remainder of them is redeemed, to Aaron and to his sons. Moses took the redemption money from those who exceeded the number of those who were redeemed by the Levites. From the firstborn of the children of Israel he took the money, 1,365 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, and Moses gave the redemption money to Aaron and to his sons, according to the word of the Lord, as the Lord commanded Moses. Chapter 4. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "Take a census of the sons of Kohath from among the sons of Levi, by their families, by their fathers' houses, from 30 years old and upward even until 50 years old, all who enter into the service, to do the work in the tent of meeting. This is the service of the sons of Kohath in the tent of meeting, the most holy things. When the camp moves forward, Aaron shall go in, and his sons, and they shall take down the veil of the screen, and cover the ark of the testimony with it, and shall put a covering of sealskin on it, and shall spread over it a cloth all of blue, and shall put in its poles. On the table of showbread they shall spread a blue cloth, and put on it the dishes, the spoons, the bowls, and the pitchers for pouring with them, and the continual bread shall be on it. They shall spread on them a scarlet cloth, and cover the same with a covering of sealskin, and shall put in its poles. They shall take a blue cloth, and cover the lampstand of light, and its lamps, and its snuffers, and its snuff dishes, and all its oil vessels, with which they minister to it. They shall put it in all its vessels within a covering of sealskin, and shall put it on the frame. On the golden altar they shall spread a blue cloth, and cover it with a covering of sealskin, and shall put in its poles. They shall take all the vessels of ministry, with which they minister in the sanctuary, and put them in a blue cloth, and cover them with a covering of sealskin, and shall put them on the frame. They shall take away the ashes from the altar, and spread a purple cloth on it. They shall put on it all its vessels, with which they minister about it, the fire pans, the flesh hooks, the shovels, and the basins, all the vessels of the altar, and they shall spread on it a covering of sealskin, and put in its poles. When Aaron and his sons have finished covering the sanctuary, and all the furniture of the sanctuary, as the camp moves forward, after that, the sons of Kohath shall come to carry it, but they shall not touch the sanctuary, lest they die. These things are the burden of the sons of Kohath in the tent of meeting. The duty of Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest shall be the oil for the light, the sweet incense, the continual meal offering, and the anointing oil, the requirements of all the tabernacle, and of all that is in it, the sanctuary, and its furnishings. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "Do not cut off the tribe of the families of the Kohathites from among the Levites, but thus do to them, that they may live, and not die. When they approach to the most holy things, Aaron and his sons shall go in, and appoint them everyone to his service and to his burden, but they shall not go in to see the sanctuary even for a moment, lest they die." The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Take a census of the sons of Gershon also, by their fathers' houses, by their families, you shall count them from 30 years old and upward until 50 years old, all who enter in to wait on the service, to do the work in the tent of meeting. This is the service of the families of the Gershonites, in serving and in bearing burdens. They shall carry the curtains of the tabernacle, and the tent of meeting, its covering, and the covering of sealskin that is above on it, and the screen for the door of the tent of meeting, and the tapestries of the court, and the screen for the door of the gate of the court, which is by the tabernacle and around the altar, and their cords, and all the instruments of their service, and whatever shall be done with them. So they are to serve. At the commandment of Aaron and his sons shall be all the service of the sons of the Gershonites, in all their burden, and in all their service, And you shall appoint their duty to them in all their responsibilities. This is the service of the families of the sons of the Gershonites in the tent of meeting, and their duty shall be under the hand of Itamar the son of Aaron the priest. As for the sons of Merari, you shall number them by their families, by their fathers' houses, you shall count them from 30 years old and upward even to 50 years old, everyone who enters on the service, to do the work of the tent of meeting. This is the duty of their burden, according to all their service in the tent of meeting, the tabernacle's boards, its bars, its pillars, its sockets, and the pillars of the court around it, and their sockets, and their pins, and their cords, with all their instruments, and with all their service, and by name you shall appoint the instruments of the duty of their burden. This is the service of the families of the sons of Merari, according to all their service, in the tent of meeting, under the hand of Itamar the son of Aaron the priest. Moses and Aaron and the leaders of the congregation numbered the sons of the Kohathites by their families, and by their fathers' houses, from 30 years old and upward even to 50 years old, everyone who entered into the service, for work in the tent of meeting. Those who were numbered of them by their families were 2,750. These are those who were numbered of the families of the Kohathites, all who served in the tent of meeting, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the commandment of the Lord by Moses. Those who were numbered of the sons of Gershon, their families, and by their fathers' houses, from 30 years old and upward even to 50 years old, everyone who entered into the service, for work in the tent of meeting, even those who were numbered of them, by their families, by their fathers' houses, were 2,630. These are those who were numbered of the families of the sons of Gershon, all who served in the tent of meeting, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the commandment of the Lord. Those who were numbered of the families of the sons of Merari, by their families, by their fathers' houses, from 30 years old and upward even to 50 years old, everyone who entered into the service, for work in the tent of meeting, even those who were numbered of them by their families, were 3,200. These are those who were numbered of the families of the sons of Merari, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the commandment of the Lord by Moses. All those who were numbered of the Levites, whom Moses and Aaron and the leaders of Israel numbered, by their families, and by their fathers' houses, from 30 years old and upward even to 50 years old, everyone who entered in to do the work of service, and the work of bearing burdens in the tent of meeting, even those who were numbered of them, were 8,580. According to the commandment of the Lord they were numbered by Moses, everyone according to his service, and according to his burden. Thus were they numbered by him, as the Lord commanded Moses. Chapter 5. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, command the children of Israel that they put out of the camp every leper, and everyone who has an issue, and whoever is unclean by the dead. Both you shall put male and female outside of the camp, that they not defile their camp, in the midst of which I dwell. The children of Israel did so, and put them out outside of the camp, as the Lord spoke to Moses, so did the children of Israel. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Israel, when a man or woman commits any sin that men commit, so as to trespass against the Lord, and that soul is guilty, then he shall confess his sin which he has done, and he shall make restitution for his guilt in full, and add to it the fifth part of it, and give it to him in respect of whom he has been guilty. But if the man has no kinsman to whom restitution may be made for the guilt, the restitution for guilt which is made to the Lord shall be the priest's, besides the ram of the atonement, by which atonement shall be made for him. Every heave offering of all the holy things of the children of Israel, which they present to the priest, shall be his. Every man's holy things shall be his, whatever any man gives the priest, it shall be his. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, if any man's wife goes astray, and is unfaithful to him, and a man lies with her carnally, and it is hidden from the eyes of her husband, and is kept close, and she is defiled, and there is no witness against her, and she isn't taken in the act, and the spirit of jealousy comes on him, and he is jealous of his wife, and she is defiled, or if the spirit of jealousy comes on him, and he is jealous of his wife, and she isn't defiled, then the man shall bring his wife to the priest, and shall bring her offering for her, the tenth part of an ephah of barley meal. He shall pour no oil on it, nor put frankincense on it, for it is a meal offering of jealousy, a meal offering of memorial, bringing iniquity to memory. The priest shall bring her near, and set her before the Lord, and the priest shall take holy water in an earthen vessel, and of the dust that is on the floor of the tabernacle the priest shall take, and put it into the water. The priest shall set the woman before the Lord, and let the hair of the woman's head go loose, and put the meal offering of memorial in her hands, which is the meal offering of jealousy. The priest shall have in his hand the water of bitterness that brings a curse. The priest shall cause her to swear, and shall tell the woman, if no man has lain with you, and if you haven't gone aside to uncleanness, being under your husband, be free from this water of bitterness that brings a curse. But if you have gone astray, being under your husband, and if you are defiled, and some man has lain with you besides your husband, then the priest shall cause the woman to swear with the oath of cursing, and the priest shall tell the woman, the Lord make you a curse and an oath among your people, when the Lord allows your thigh to fall away, and your body to swell, and this water that brings a curse will go into your bowels, and make your body swell, and your thigh fall away. The woman shall say, Amen, Amen. The priest shall write these curses on a scroll, and he shall blot them out into the water of bitterness. He shall make the woman drink the water of bitterness that causes the curse, and the water that causes the curse shall enter into her and become bitter. The priest shall take the meal offering of jealousy out of the woman's hand, and shall wave the meal offering before the Lord, and bring it to the altar. The priest shall take a handful of the meal offering, as its memorial, and burn it on the altar, and afterwards shall make the woman drink the water. When he has made her drink the water, then it shall happen, if she is defiled, and has committed a trespass against her husband, that the water that causes the curse will enter into her and become bitter, and her body will swell, and her thigh will fall away, and the woman will be a curse among her people. If the woman isn't defiled, but is clean, then she shall be free and will conceive children. This is the law of jealousy: when a wife, being under her husband, goes astray, and is defiled, or when the spirit of jealousy comes on a man, and he is jealous of his wife, then he shall set the woman before the Lord, and the priest shall execute on her all this law. The man shall be free from iniquity, and that woman shall bear her iniquity. Chapter 6. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, when either man or woman shall make a special vow, the vow of a Nazarite, to separate himself to the Lord, he shall separate himself from wine and strong drink. He shall drink no vinegar of wine, or vinegar of fermented drink, neither shall he drink any juice of grapes, nor eat fresh grapes or dried. All the days of his separation he shall eat nothing that is made of the grapevine, from the seeds even to the skins. All the days of his vow of separation there shall no razor come on his head, until the days are fulfilled, in which he separates himself to the Lord. He shall be holy. He shall let the locks of the hair of his head grow long. All the days that he separates himself to the Lord he shall not go near a dead body. He shall not make himself unclean for his father, or for his mother, for his brother, or for his sister, when they die, because his separation to God is on his head. All the days of his separation he is holy to the Lord. If any man dies very suddenly beside him, and he defiles the head of his separation, then he shall shave his head in the day of his cleansing. On the seventh day he shall shave it. On the eighth day he shall bring two turtle doves or two young pigeons to the priest, to the door of the tent of meeting. The priest shall offer one for a sin offering, and the other for a burnt offering, and make atonement for him, because he sinned by reason of a dead, and shall make his head holy that same day. He shall separate to the Lord the days of his separation, and shall bring a male lamb a year old for a trespass offering, but the former days shall be void, because his separation was defiled. This is the law of the Nazarite: when the days of his separation are fulfilled, he shall be brought to the door of the tent of meeting, and he shall offer his offering to the Lord, one male lamb a year old without blemish for a burnt offering, and one ewe lamb a year old without blemish for a sin offering, and one ram without blemish for peace offerings, and a basket of unleavened bread, cakes of fine flour mixed with oil, and unleavened wafers anointed with oil, and their meal offering, and their drink offerings. The priest shall present them before the Lord, and shall offer his sin offering, and his burnt offering. He shall offer the ram for a sacrifice of peace offerings to the Lord, with the basket of unleavened bread. The priest shall offer also its meal offering, and its drink offering. The Nazarite shall shave the head of his separation at the door of the tent of meeting, and shall take the hair of the head of his separation, and put it on the fire which is under the sacrifice of peace offerings. The priest shall take the boiled shoulder of the ram, and one unleavened cake out of the basket, and one unleavened wafer, and shall put them on the hands of the Nazarite, after he has shaved the head of his separation, and the priest shall wave them for a wave offering before the Lord. This is holy for the priest, together with the breast that is waved and the thigh that is offered. After that the Nazarite may drink wine. This is the law of the Nazarite who vows, and of his offering to the Lord for his separation, besides that which he is able to get. According to his vow which he vows, so he must do after the law of his separation. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to Aaron and to his sons, saying, This is how you shall bless the children of Israel. You shall tell them, The Lord bless you, and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you, and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his face toward you, and give you peace. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. Chapter 7. It happened on the day that Moses had finished setting up the tabernacle, and had anointed it and sanctified it, with all its furniture, and the altar with all its vessels, and had anointed and sanctified them, that the leaders of Israel, the heads of their ancestral houses, offered. These were the leaders of the tribes. These are they who were over those who were numbered, and they brought their offering before the Lord, 6 covered wagons, and 12 oxen, a wagon for every 2 of the leaders, and for each one an ox, and they presented them before the tabernacle. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Accept these from them, that they may be used in doing the service of the tent of meeting, and you shall give them to the Levites, to every man according to his service. Moses took the wagons and the oxen, and gave them to the Levites. He gave 2 wagons and 4 oxen to the sons of Gershon, according to their service, and he gave 4 wagons and 8 oxen to the sons of Merari, according to their service, under the direction of Itamar the son of Aaron the priest. But to the sons of Kohath he gave none, because the service of the sanctuary belonged to them, they carried it on their shoulders. And the leaders gave offerings for the dedication of the altar in the day that it was anointed, even the leaders gave their offerings before the altar. The Lord said to Moses, They shall offer their offering, each prince on his day, for the dedication of the altar. He who offered his offering the first day was Nashon the son of Amminadab, of the tribe of Judah, and his offering was, 1 silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, 1 silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, 1 golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 1 male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, 1 male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, 2 head of cattle, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Nashon the son of Amminadab. On the second day Nathanael the son of Zur, prince of Issachar, gave his offering. He offered for his offering, 1 silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, 1 silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, 1 golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 1 male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, 1 male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, 2 head of cattle, 5 rams, 5 male goats, 5 male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Nethanel the son of Zur. On the third day Eliab the son of Helon, prince of the children of Zebulun gave his offering, 1 silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, 1 silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, 1 golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 1 male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, 1 male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, 2 head of cattle, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Eliab the son of Helon. On the fourth day Elitzur the son of Shadur, prince of the children of Reuben gave his offering, 1 silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, 1 silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, 1 golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 1 male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, 1 male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, 2 head of cattle, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Elitzur the son of Shadur. On the fifth day Shalumiel the son of Zurishaddai, prince of the children of Simeon gave his offering, 1 silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, 1 silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, 1 golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 1 male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, 1 male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, 2 head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Shelumiel the son of Zurishaddai. On the sixth day, Eliasaph the son of Reuel, prince of the children of Gad, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Eliasaph the son of Reuel. On the seventh day Elishama the son of Ammihud, prince of the children of Ephraim, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Elishama the son of Ammihud. On the eighth day Gamaliel the son of Pedazur, prince of the children of Manasseh, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. On the ninth day Abidan the son of Gideoni, prince of the children of Benjamin, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Abidan the son of Gideoni. On the tenth day Ahizar the son of Ammishaddai, prince of the children of Dan, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Ahizar the son of Ammishaddai. On the 11th day Pagiel the son of Ochran, prince of the children of Asher, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden ladle of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Pagiel the son of Ochran. On the 12th day Ahira the son of Enon, prince of the children of Naphtali, gave his offering, one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, one silver bowl of 70 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering, one golden spoon of 10 shekels, full of incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two head of cattle, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old. This was the offering of Ahira the son of Enon. This was the dedication of the altar, on the day when it was anointed, by the leaders of Israel, 12 silver platters, 12 silver bowls, 12 golden ladles, each silver platter weighing 130 shekels, and each bowl 70, all the silver of the vessels 2,400 shekels, after the shekel of the sanctuary, The 12 golden ladles, full of incense, weighing 10 shekels apiece, after the shekel of the sanctuary, all the gold of the ladles weighed 120 shekels, all the cattle for the burnt offering 12 bulls, the rams 12, the male lambs a year old 12, and their meal offering, and the male goats for a sin offering 12, and all the cattle for the sacrifice of peace offerings 24 bulls, the rams 60, the male goats 60, the male lambs a year old 60. This was the dedication of the altar, after it was anointed. When Moses went into the tent of meeting to speak with the Lord, he heard his voice speaking to him from above the mercy seat that was on the Ark of the Testimony, from between the two cherubim, and he spoke to him. Chapter 8. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron, and tell him, when you light the lamps, the seven lamps shall give light in front of the lampstand." Aaron did so. He lit its lamps to light the area in front of the lampstand, as the Lord commanded Moses. This was the workmanship of the lampstand, beaten work of gold. From its base to its flowers, it was beaten work, according to the pattern which the Lord had shown Moses, so he made the lampstand. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Take the Levites from among the children of Israel, and cleanse them. You shall do this to them, to cleanse them, sprinkle the water of cleansing on them, let them shave their whole bodies with a razor, and let them wash their clothes, and cleanse themselves. Then let them take a young bull, and its meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, and another young bull you shall take for a sin offering. You shall present the Levites before the tent of meeting. You shall assemble the whole congregation of the children of Israel. You shall present the Levites before the Lord. The children of Israel shall lay their hands on the Levites, and Aaron shall offer the Levites before the Lord for a wave offering, on the behalf of the children of Israel, that it may be theirs to do the service of the Lord. The Levites shall lay their hands on the heads of the bulls, and you shall offer the one for a sin offering, and the other for a burnt offering to the Lord, to make atonement for the Levites. You shall set the Levites before Aaron, and before his sons, and offer them as a wave offering to the Lord. Thus you shall separate the Levites from among the children of Israel, and the Levites shall be mine. After that, the Levites shall go in to do the service of the tent of meeting, and you shall cleanse them, and offer them as a wave offering. For they are wholly given to me from among the children of Israel, instead of all who open the womb, even the firstborn of all the children of Israel, I have taken them to me. For all the firstborn among the children of Israel are mine, both man and animal. On the day that I struck all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, I sanctify them for myself. I have taken the Levites instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel. I have given the Levites as a gift to Aaron and to his sons from among the children of Israel, to do the service of the children of Israel in the tent of meeting, and to make atonement for the children of Israel, that there be no plague among the children of Israel, when the children of Israel come near to the sanctuary." Moses, and Aaron, and all the congregation of the children of Israel did so to the Levites. According to all that the Lord commanded Moses concerning the Levites, so the children of Israel did to them. The Levites purified themselves from sin, and they washed their clothes, and Aaron offered them for a wave offering before the Lord, and Aaron made atonement for them to cleanse them. After that, the Levites went in to do their service in the tent of meeting before Aaron, and before his sons, as the Lord had commanded Moses concerning the Levites, so they did to them. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "This is that which belongs to the Levites, from 25 years old and upward they shall go in to wait on the service in the work of the tent of meeting, and from the age of 50 years they shall cease waiting on the work, and shall serve no more, but shall minister with their brothers in the tent of meeting, to perform the duty, and shall do no service. You shall do thus to the Levites concerning their duties." Chapter 9. The Lord spoke to Moses in the wilderness of Sinai, in the first month of the second year after they had come out of the land of Egypt, saying, "Moreover, let the children of Israel keep the Passover in its appointed season. On the 14th day of this month, at evening, you shall keep it in its appointed season according to all its statutes, and according to all its ordinances, you shall keep it." Moses spoke to the children of Israel, that they should keep the Passover. They kept the Passover in the first month, on the 14th day of the month, at evening, in the wilderness of Sinai. According to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so the children of Israel did. There were certain men, who were unclean because of the dead body of a man, so that they could not keep the Passover on that day, and they came before Moses and before Aaron on that day. Those men said to him, "We are unclean because of the dead body of a man. Why are we kept back, that we may not offer the offering of the Lord in its appointed season among the children of Israel? Moses answered them, Wait, that I may hear what the Lord will command concerning you. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Say to the children of Israel, If any man of you or of your generations is unclean by reason of a dead body, or is on a journey far away, he shall still keep the Passover to the Lord. In the second month, on the 14th day at evening they shall keep it, they shall eat it with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. They shall leave none of it until the morning, nor break a bone of it. According to all the statute of the Passover they shall keep it. But the man who is clean, and is not on a journey, and fails to keep the Passover, that soul shall be cut off from his people. Because he did not offer the offering of the Lord in its appointed season, that man shall bear his sin. If a foreigner lives among you, and desires to keep the Passover to the Lord, according to the statute of the Passover, and according to its ordinance, so shall he do. You shall have one statute, both for the foreigner, and for him who is born in the land. On the day that the tabernacle was raised up, the cloud covered the tabernacle, even the tent of the testimony, and at evening it was over the tabernacle as it were the appearance of fire, until morning. So it was continually. The cloud covered it by day, and the appearance of fire by night. Whenever the cloud was taken up from over the tent, then after that the children of Israel traveled, and in the place where the cloud remained, there the children of Israel camped. At the commandment of the Lord, the children of Israel traveled, and at the commandment of the Lord they camped. As long as the cloud remained on the tabernacle they remained camped. When the cloud stayed on the tabernacle many days, then the children of Israel kept the command of God, and did not travel. Sometimes the cloud was a few days on the tabernacle, then according to the commandment of the Lord they remained camped, and according to the commandment of the Lord they traveled. Sometimes the cloud was from evening until morning, and when the cloud was taken up in the morning, they traveled, or by day and by night, when the cloud was taken up, they traveled. Whether it was 2 days, or a month, or a year that the cloud stayed on the tabernacle, remaining on it, the children of Israel remained camped, and did not travel, but when it was taken up, they traveled. At the commandment of the Lord they camped, and at the commandment of the Lord they traveled. They kept the Lord's command, at the commandment of the Lord by Moses. Chapter 10. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Make 2 trumpets of silver. You shall make them of beaten work. You shall use them for the calling of the congregation, and for the journeying of the camps. When they blow them, all the congregation shall gather themselves to you at the door of the tent of meeting. But if they blow just one, then the leaders, the heads of the thousands of Israel, shall gather themselves to you. When you blow an alarm, the camps that lie on the east side shall go forward. When you blow an alarm the second time, the camps that lie on the south side shall go forward. They shall blow an alarm for their journeys. But when the assembly is to be gathered together, you shall blow, but you shall not sound an alarm. The sons of Aaron, the priests, shall blow the trumpets. This shall be to you for a statute forever throughout your generations. When you go to war in your land against the adversary who oppresses you, then you shall sound an alarm with the trumpets. Then you will be remembered before the Lord your God, and you will be saved from your enemies. Also in the day of your gladness, and in your set feasts, and in the beginnings of your months, you shall blow the trumpets over your burnt offerings, and over the sacrifices of your peace offerings, and they shall be to you for a memorial before your God. I am the Lord your God. It happened in the second year, in the second month, on the 20th day of the month, that the cloud was taken up from over the tabernacle of the testimony. The children of Israel went forward according to their journeys out of the wilderness of Sinai, and the cloud abode in the wilderness of Paran. They first went forward according to the commandment of the Lord by Moses. First, the standard of the camp of the children of Judah went forward according to their armies. Nashon the son of Amminadab was over his army. Nethanel the son of Zur was over the army of the tribe of the children of Issachar. Eliab the son of Helon was over the army of the tribe of the children of Zebulun. The tabernacle was taken down, and the sons of Gershon and the sons of Merari, who bore the tabernacle, went forward. The standard of the camp of Reuben went forward according to their armies. Eletzer the son of Shadur was over his army. Shalumiel the son of Zurishaddai was over the army of the tribe of the children of Simeon. Eliasaph the son of Reuel was over the army of the tribe of the children of Gad. The Kohathites set forward, bearing the sanctuary. The others set up the tabernacle before they arrived. The standard of the camp of the children of Ephraim set forward according to their armies. Elishama the son of Ammihud was over his army. Gamaliel the son of Pedazur was over the army of the tribe of the children of Manasseh. Avidan the son of Gideoni was over the army of the tribe of the children of Benjamin. The standard of the camp of the children of Dan, which was the rearward of all the camps, set forward according to their armies. Ahizer the son of Amishaddai was over his army. Pagiel the son of Ochran was over the army of the tribe of the children of Asher. Ahara the son of Enon was over the army of the tribe of the children of Naphtali. Thus were the travels of the children of Israel according to their armies, and they went forward. Moses said to Hobab, the son of Reuel the Midianite, Moses' brother-in-law, we are journeying to the place of which the Lord said, I will give it to you. Come with us, and we will treat you well, for the Lord has spoken good concerning Israel. He said to him, I will not go, but I will depart to my own land, and to my relatives. He said, do not leave us, please, because you know how we are to camp in the wilderness, and you can be our eyes. And it shall be, if you go with us, that it shall be that whatever good the Lord does to us, we will do the same to you. They set forward from the mount of the Lord 3 days' journey. The Ark of the Covenant of the Lord went before them 3 days' journey, to seek out a resting place for them. The cloud of the Lord was over them by day, when they set forward from the camp. It happened, when the Ark went forward, that Moses said, Rise up, Lord, and let your enemies be scattered. Let those who hate you flee before you. When it rested, he said, Return, Lord, to the 10,000s of the thousands of Israel. Chapter 11. The people were complaining in the ears of the Lord. When the Lord heard it, his anger was kindled, and the Lord's fire burned among them, and consumed some of the outskirts of the camp. The people cried to Moses, and Moses prayed to the Lord, and the fire abated. The name of that place was called Taberah, because the Lord's fire burned among them. The mixed multitude that was among them lusted exceedingly, and the children of Israel also wept again, and said, Who will give us flesh to eat? We remember the fish, which we ate in Egypt for nothing, the cucumbers, and the melons, and the leeks, and the onions, and the garlic, but now we have lost our appetite. There is nothing at all except this manna to look at. The manna was like coriander seed, and its appearance like the appearance of delium. The people went around, gathered it, and ground it in mills, or beat it in mortars, and boiled it in pots, and made cakes of it. Its taste was like the taste of fresh oil. When the dew fell on the camp in the night, the manna fell on it. Moses heard the people weeping throughout their families, every man at the door of his tent, and the anger of the Lord was kindled greatly, and Moses was displeased. Moses said to the Lord, Why have you treated with your servant so badly? Why haven't I found favor in your sight, that you lay the burden of all this people on me? Have I conceived all this people? Have I brought them forth, that you should tell me, Carry them in your bosom, as a nurse carries a nursing infant, to the land which you swore to their fathers? Where could I get meat to give to all this people? For they weep to me, saying, Give us meat, that we may eat. I am not able to bear all this people alone, because it is too heavy for me. If you treat me this way, please kill me right now, if I have found favor in your sight, and do not let me see my wretchedness. The Lord said to Moses, Gather to me 70 men of the elders of Israel, whom you know to be the elders of the people, and officers over them, and bring them to the tent of meeting, that they may stand there with you. I will come down and talk with you there. I will take of the spirit which is on you, and will put it on them, and they shall bear the burden of the people with you, that you not bear it yourself alone. Say to the people, Sanctify yourselves against tomorrow, and you will eat flesh, for you have wept in the ears of the Lord, saying, Who will give us flesh to eat? For it was well with us in Egypt. Therefore the Lord will give you flesh, and you will eat. You will not eat 1 day, nor 2 days, nor 5 days, neither 10 days, nor 20 days, but a whole month, until it come out at your nostrils, and it is loathsome to you, because that you have rejected the Lord who is among you, and have wept before him, saying, Why did we come out of Egypt? Moses said, The people, among whom I am, are 600,000 men on foot, and you have said, I will give them flesh, that they may eat a whole month. Shall flocks and herds be slaughtered for them, to be sufficient for them? Shall all the fish of the sea be gathered together for them, to be sufficient for them? The Lord said to Moses, Has the Lord's hand grown short? Now you will see whether my word will happen to you or not. Moses went out, and told the people the words of the Lord, and he gathered 70 men of the elders of the people, and set them around the tent. The Lord came down in the cloud, and spoke to him, and took of the spirit that was on him, and put it on the 70 elders, and it happened that when the Spirit rested on them, they prophesied, but they did so no more, but two men remained in the camp. The name of one was Eldad, and the name of the other Medad, and the Spirit rested on them, and they were of those who were written, but had not gone out to the tent, and they prophesied in the camp. A young man ran, and told Moses, and said, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp. Joshua the son of Nun, the servant of Moses, one of his chosen men, answered, My lord Moses, forbid them. Moses said to him, Are you jealous for my sake? I wish that all the Lord's people were prophets, that the Lord would put his Spirit on them. Moses went into the camp, he and the elders of Israel. A wind from the Lord went out and brought quails from the sea, and let them fall by the camp, about a day's journey on this side, and a day's journey on the other side, around the camp, and about 3 feet above the ground. The people rose up all that day, and all the night, and all the next day, and gathered the quails. He who gathered least gathered 10 homers, and they spread them all abroad for themselves around the camp. While the flesh was yet between their teeth, before it was chewed, the anger of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord struck the people with a very great plague. The name of that place was called Kibroth Hattaava, because there they buried the people who lusted. From Kibroth Hattaava the people traveled to Hazeroth, and they stayed at Hazeroth. Chapter 12. Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses because of the Cushite woman whom he had married, for he had married a Cushite woman. They said, Has the Lord indeed spoken only with Moses? Hasn't he spoken also with us? And the Lord heard it. Now the man Moses was very humble, above all the men who were on the surface of the earth. The Lord spoke suddenly to Moses, to Aaron, and to Miriam, You three come out to the tent of meeting. The three of them came out. The Lord came down in a pillar of cloud, and stood at the door of the tent, and called Aaron and Miriam, and they both came forward. He said, Hear now my words. If there is a prophet among you, I the Lord will make myself known to him in a vision. I will speak with him in a dream. My servant Moses is not so. He is faithful in all my house. With him I will speak mouth to mouth, even openly, and not in riddles, and he shall see the Lord's form. Why then were you not afraid to speak against my servant, against Moses? The anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he departed. The cloud departed from over the tent, and look, Miriam was leprous, as white as snow. Aaron looked at Miriam, and look, she was leprous. Aaron said to Moses, Oh, my Lord, please do not count this sin against us, in which we have done foolishly, and in which we have sinned. Let her not, I pray, be as one dead, of whom the flesh is half consumed when he comes out of his mother's womb. Moses cried to the Lord, saying, Heal her, God, I beg you. The Lord said to Moses, If her father had but spit in her face, shouldn't she be ashamed 7 days? Let her be shut up outside of the camp 7 days, and after that she shall be brought in again. Miriam was shut up outside of the camp 7 days, and the people did not travel until Miriam was brought in again. Afterward the people traveled from Hazeroth, and camped in the wilderness of Paran. Chapter 13. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Send men, that they may spy out the land of Canaan, which I give to the children of Israel. Of every tribe of their fathers, you shall send a man, every one a prince among them. Moses sent them from the wilderness of Paran according to the commandment of the Lord, all of them men who were heads of the children of Israel. These were their names, of the tribe of Reuben, Shammah the son of Zakur. Of the tribe of Simeon, Shaphat the son of Hori. Of the tribe of Judah, Caleb the son of Jephunneh. Of the tribe of Issachar, Egal the son of Joseph. Of the tribe of Ephraim, Hoshea the son of Nun. Of the tribe of Benjamin, Palti the son of Raphu. Of the tribe of Zebulun, Gadiel the son of Sodi. Of the tribe of Joseph, of the tribe of Manasseh, Gadi the son of Susi. Of the tribe of Dan, Amiel the son of Gamali. Of the tribe of Asher, Sothur the son of Michael. Of the tribe of Naphtali, Nabi the son of Vophsi. Of the tribe of Gad, Gul the son of Machi. These are the names of the men who Moses sent to spy out the land. Moses called Hoshea the son of Nun Joshua. Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan, and said to them, Go up this way by the Negev, and go up into the hill country, and see the land, what it is, and the people who dwell in it, whether they are strong or weak, whether they are few or many, and what the land is that they dwell in, whether it is good or bad, and what cities there are that they dwell in, whether in camps, or in strongholds, and what the land is, whether it is fat or lean, whether there is wood in it, or not. Be courageous, and bring of the fruit of the land. Now the time was the time of the first ripe grapes. So they went up, and spied out the land from the wilderness of Zin to Rehob, to Lebo Hamath. They went up by the Negev, and came to Hebron, and Ahiman, Shishai, and Talmai, the children of Anak, were there. Now Hebron was built 7 years before Zoan in Egypt. They came to the valley of Eshcol, and cut down from there a branch with one cluster of grapes on it, and they bore it on a staff between two. They also brought some of the pomegranates and figs. That place was called the Valley of Eshcol, because of the cluster which the children of Israel cut down from there. They returned from spying out the land at the end of 40 days. They went and came to Moses, and to Aaron, and to all the congregation of the children of Israel, to the wilderness of Paran, to Kadesh, and brought back word to them, and to all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. They told him, and said, "We came to the land where you sent us, and surely it flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. However, the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large. Moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. Amalek dwells in the land of the Negev, and the Hittites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites, and the Amorites, dwell in the hill country, and the Canaanite dwells by the sea, and along by the side of the Jordan." Caleb stilled the people before Moses, and said, "Let us go up at once, and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it." But the men who went up with him said, "We aren't able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we." They brought up an evil report of the land which they had spied out to the children of Israel, saying, "The land, through which we have gone to spy it out, is a land that eats up its inhabitants, and all the people who we saw in it are men of great stature. There we saw the Nephilim, the sons of Anak, who come of the Nephilim, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we were in their sight." Chapter 14. All the congregation lifted up their voice, and cried, and the people wept that night. All the children of Israel murmured against Moses and against Aaron, and the whole congregation said to them, "Would that we had died in the land of Egypt! Or would that we had died in this wilderness! Why does the Lord bring us to this land, to fall by the sword? Our wives and our little ones will be a prey. Wouldn't it be better for us to return into Egypt?" And they said to one another, "Let us make a captain, and let us return into Egypt." Then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before all the assembly of the congregation of the children of Israel. Joshua the son of Nun and Caleb the son of Jephunneh, who were of those who spied out the land, tore their clothes, and they spoke to all the congregation of the children of Israel, saying, "The land, which we pass through to spy it out, is an exceeding good land. If the Lord delights in us, then he will bring us into this land, and give it to us, a land which flows with milk and honey. Only do not rebel against the Lord, neither fear the people of the land, for they are bred for us, their defense is removed from over them, and the Lord is with us. Do not fear them." But all the congregation threatened to stone them with stones. Then the glory of the Lord appeared at the tent of meeting to all the children of Israel. The Lord said to Moses, "How long will this people despise me? And how long will they not believe in me, for all the signs which I have worked among them? I will strike them with the pestilence, and disinherit them, and I will make of you and your father's house a nation greater and mightier than they." Moses said to the Lord, "Then the Egyptians will hear it, for you brought up this people in your might from among them, and they will tell it to the inhabitants of this land. They have heard that you, Lord, are in the midst of this people, for you, Lord, are seen face to face, and your cloud stands over them, and you go before them, in a pillar of cloud by day, and in a pillar of fire by night. Now if you killed this people as one man, then the nations which have heard the fame of you will speak, saying, 'Because the Lord was not able to bring this people into the land which he swore to them, therefore he has slain them in the wilderness.' Now please let the power of the Lord be great, according as you have spoken, saying, 'The Lord is slow to anger, and abundant in loving kindness, forgiving iniquity and disobedience, and that will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers on the children, on the third and on the fourth generation. Please pardon the iniquity of this people according to the greatness of your loving kindness, and according as you have forgiven this people, from Egypt even until now.'" The Lord said, "I have pardoned according to your word. But truly, as I live, and as all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord, because all those men who have seen my glory, and my signs, which I worked in Egypt and in the wilderness, yet have tempted me these 10 times, and have not listened to my voice, surely they shall not see the land which I swore to their fathers, neither shall any of those who despised me see it, But my servant Caleb, because he had another spirit with him, and has followed me fully, him will I bring into the land into which he went, and his descendants shall possess it. Now the Amalekite and the Canaanite dwell in the valley, tomorrow turn, and go into the wilderness by the way to the Sea of Suf. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, How long shall I bear with this evil congregation, that murmur against me? I have heard the murmurings of the children of Israel, which they murmur against me. Tell them, As I live, says the Lord, surely as you have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you, your dead bodies shall fall in this wilderness, and all who were numbered of you, according to your whole number, from 20 years old and upward, who have murmured against me, surely you shall not come into the land, concerning which I swore that I would make you dwell in it, except Caleb the son of Jephunneh, and Joshua the son of Nun. But your little ones, that you said should be a prey, them will I bring in, and they shall know the land which you have rejected. But as for you, your dead bodies shall fall in this wilderness. Your children shall be wanderers in the wilderness 40 years, and shall bear your prostitution, until your dead bodies be consumed in the wilderness. After the number of the days in which ye spied out the land, even 40 days, for every day a year, you will bear your iniquities, even 40 years, and you will know my alienation. I, the Lord, have spoken, surely this will I do to all this evil congregation, who are gathered together against me, in this wilderness they shall be consumed, and there they shall die. The men, whom Moses sent to spy out the land, who returned, and made all the congregation to murmur against him, by bringing up an evil report against the land, even those men who brought up an evil report of the land, died by the plague before the Lord. But Joshua the son of Nun, and Caleb the son of Jephunneh, remained alive of those men who went to spy out the land. Moses told these words to all the children of Israel, and the people mourned greatly. They rose up early in the morning, and went up to the top of the mountain, saying, Look, we are here, and will go up to the place which the Lord has promised, for we have sinned. Moses said, Why now do you disobey the commandment of the Lord, since it shall not prosper? Do not go up, for the Lord isn't among you, that you not be struck down before your enemies. For there the Amalekite and the Canaanite are before you, and you shall fall by the sword, because you are turned back from following the Lord, therefore the Lord will not be with you. But they presumed to go up to the top of the mountain. Nevertheless the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, and Moses, did not depart out of the camp. Then the Amalekite came down, and the Canaanite who lived in that mountain, and struck them and beat them down, even to Hormah. Chapter 15. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, When you have come into the land of your habitations, which I give to you, and will make an offering by fire to the Lord, a burnt offering, or a sacrifice, to accomplish a vow, or as a freewill offering, or in your set feasts, to make a pleasant aroma to the Lord, of the herd, or of the flock, then he who offers his offering shall offer to the Lord a meal offering of a tenth part of an ephah of fine flour mixed with a fourth part of a hin of oil, and wine for the drink offering, the fourth part of a hin, you shall prepare with a burnt offering, or for the sacrifice, for each lamb, or for a ram, you shall prepare for a meal offering 2/10 parts of an ephah of fine flour mixed with the third part of a hin of oil, and for the drink offering you shall offer the third part of a hin of wine, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord. When you prepare a bull for a burnt offering, or for a sacrifice, to accomplish a vow, or for peace offerings to the Lord, then shall he offer with the bull a meal offering of 3/10 parts of an ephah of fine flour mixed with half a hin of oil, and you shall offer for the drink offering half a hin of wine, for an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord. Thus shall it be done for each bull, or for each ram, or for each of the male lambs, or of the young goats. According to the number that you shall prepare, so you shall do to everyone according to their number. All who are native born shall do these things in this way, in offering an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord. If a stranger lives as a foreigner with you, or whoever may be among you throughout your generations, and will offer an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord, as you do, so he shall do. For the assembly, there shall be one statute for you, and for the stranger who lives among you, a statute forever throughout your generations, as you are, so shall the foreigner be before the Lord. One law and one ordinance shall be for you, and for the stranger who lives as a foreigner with you. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, When you come into the land where I bring you, then it shall be that when you eat of the bread of the land, You shall offer up a wave offering to the Lord. Of the first of your dough you shall offer up a cake for a wave offering, as the wave offering of the threshing floor, so you shall heave it. Of the first of your dough you shall give to the Lord a wave offering throughout your generations. When you shall and not observe all these commandments, which the Lord has spoken to Moses, even all that the Lord has commanded you by Moses, from the day that the Lord gave commandment, and onward throughout your generations, then it shall be, if it be done unwittingly, without the knowledge of the congregation, that all the congregation shall offer one young bull for a burnt offering, for a pleasant aroma to the Lord, with the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it, according to the ordinance, and one male goat for a sin offering. The priest shall make atonement for all the congregation of the children of Israel, and they shall be forgiven, for it was an error, and they have brought their offering, an offering made by fire to the Lord, and their sin offering before the Lord, for their error, and all the congregation of the children of Israel shall be forgiven, and the stranger who lives as a foreigner among them, for in respect of all the people it was done unwittingly. If one person sins unwittingly, then he shall offer a female goat a year old for a sin offering. The priest shall make atonement for the soul who errs, when he sins unwittingly, before the Lord, to make atonement for him, and he shall be forgiven. You shall have one law for him who does anything unwittingly, for him who is native born among the children of Israel, and for the stranger who lives as a foreigner among them. But the person who acts defiantly, whether he is native born or a foreigner, the same blasphemes God, and that person is to be cut off from among his people. Because he has despised the word of the Lord, and has broken his commandment, that soul shall utterly be cut off, his iniquity shall be on him. While the children of Israel were in the wilderness, they found a man gathering sticks on the Sabbath day. Those who found him gathering sticks brought him to Moses and Aaron, and to all the congregation. They put him in custody, because it had not been declared what should be done to him. The Lord said to Moses, "The man shall surely be put to death. All the congregation shall stone him with stones outside of the camp." All the congregation brought him outside of the camp, and stoned him to death with stones, as the Lord commanded Moses. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them that they should make themselves fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations, and that they put on the fringe of each border a cord of blue, and it shall be to you for a fringe, that you may look on it, and remember all the commandments of the Lord, and do them, and that you not follow after your own heart and your own eyes, after which you used to play the prostitute, that you may remember and do all my commandments, and be holy to your God. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, to be your God. I am the Lord your God." Chapter 16. Now Korah, the son of Izhar, the son of Kohath, the son of Levi, took Dathan and Abiram, the sons of Eliab, and On, the son of Peleth, son of Reuben, and they rose up before Moses, with certain of the children of Israel, 250 leaders of the congregation, called to the assembly, men of renown, and they assembled themselves together against Moses and against Aaron, and said to them, "You take too much on yourself, since all the congregation are holy, every one of them, and the Lord is among them. Why then lift yourselves up above the assembly of the Lord?" When Moses heard it, he fell on his face, and he spoke to Korah and to all his company, saying, "In the morning the Lord will show who are his, and who is holy, and will bring him near to him. The one whom he has chosen he will bring near to him. Do this, take censers, Korah, and all his company, and put fire in them, and put incense on them before the Lord tomorrow, and it shall be that the man whom the Lord chooses, he shall be holy. You have gone too far, you sons of Levi." Moses said to Korah, "Hear now, you sons of Levi. Is it a small thing to you, that the God of Israel has separated you from the congregation of Israel, to bring you near to himself, to do the service of the tabernacle of the Lord, and to stand before the congregation to minister to them, and that he has brought you near, and all your brothers the sons of Levi with you? And do you seek the priesthood also? Therefore you and all your company are gathered together against God. And Aaron, what is he that you murmur against him?" Moses sent to call Dathan and Abiram, the sons of Eliab, and they said, "We won't come up. Is it a small thing that you have brought us up out of a land flowing with milk and honey, to kill us in the wilderness, but you must also make yourself a prince over us? Moreover, you haven't brought us into a land flowing with milk and honey, nor given us inheritance of fields and vineyards. Will you put out the eyes of these men? We won't come up." Moses was very angry, and said to the Lord, "Do not respect their offering. I have not taken one donkey from them, neither have I hurt one of them." Moses said to Korah, "You and all your company go before the Lord, you, and they, and Aaron, tomorrow, and each man take his censer, and put incense on them, and each man bring before the Lord his censer, 250 censers, you also, and Aaron, each his censer." They each took his censer, and put fire in them, and laid incense thereon, and stood at the door of the tent of meeting with Moses and Aaron. Korah assembled all the congregation against them to the door of the tent of meeting, and the glory of the Lord appeared to all the congregation. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, "Separate yourselves from among this congregation, that I may consume them in a moment." They fell on their faces, and said, "God, the God of the spirits of all flesh, shall one man sin, and will you be angry with all the congregation?" The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to the congregation, saying, Get away from around the tent of Korah, Dathan, and Abiram." Moses rose up and went to Dathan and Abiram, and the elders of Israel followed him. He spoke to the congregation, saying, "Depart, please, from the tents of these wicked men, and touch nothing of theirs, lest you be consumed in all their sins." So they went away from the tent of Korah, Dathan, and Abiram, on every side, and Dathan and Abiram came out, and stood at the door of their tents, and their wives, and their sons, and their little ones. Moses said, "Hereby you shall know that the Lord has sent me to do all these works, for they are not from my own mind. If these men die the common death of all men, or if they be visited after the visitation of all men, then the Lord hasn't sent me. But if the Lord make a new thing, and the ground open its mouth, and swallow them up, with all that appertain to them, and they go down alive into Sheol, then you shall understand that these men have despised the Lord." It happened, as he made an end of speaking all these words, that the ground split apart that was under them, and the earth opened its mouth, and swallowed them up, and their households, and all the men who appertained to Korah, and all their goods. So they, and all that appertained to them, went down alive into Sheol, and the earth closed on them, and they perished from among the assembly. All Israel that were around them fled at their cry, for they said, "Lest the earth swallow us up." Fire came forth from the Lord, and devoured the 250 men who offered the incense. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest, that he take up the censers out of the burning, and scatter the fire yonder, for they are holy, even the censers of these sinners against their own lives, and let them be made beaten plates for a covering of the altar, for they offered them before the Lord, therefore they are holy, and they shall be assigned to the children of Israel." Eleazar the priest took the bronze censers, which those who were burnt had offered, and they beat them out for a covering of the altar, to be a memorial to the children of Israel, to the end that no stranger, who isn't of the descendants of Aaron, comes near to burn incense before the Lord, that he not be as Korah, and as his company, as the Lord spoke to him by Moses. But on the next day all the congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and against Aaron, saying, "You have killed the Lord's people." It happened, when the congregation was assembled against Moses and against Aaron, that they looked toward the tent of meeting, and look, the cloud covered it, and the glory of the Lord appeared. Moses and Aaron came to the front of the tent of meeting. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Get away from among this congregation, that I may consume them in a moment." They fell on their faces. Moses said to Aaron, "Take your censer, and put fire from off the altar in it, and lay incense on it, and carry it quickly to the congregation, and make atonement for them, for wrath has gone out from the Lord. The plague has begun." Aaron did as Moses said, and ran into the midst of the assembly, and look, the plague has begun among the people, and he put on the incense, and made atonement for the people. He stood between the dead and the living, and the plague was stayed. Now those who died by the plague were 14,700, besides those who died about the matter of Korah. Aaron returned to Moses to the door of the tent of meeting, and the plague was stayed. Chapter 17. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to the children of Israel, and take of them rods, one for each father's house, of all their princes according to their father's houses, 12 rods, write every man's name on his rod. You shall write Aaron's name on the rod of Levi, for there shall be one rod for each head of their father's houses. You shall lay them up in the tent of meeting before the testimony, where I meet with you. It shall happen, that the rod of the man whom I shall choose shall bud, and I will make to cease for me the murmurings of the children of Israel, which they murmur against you." Moses spoke to the children of Israel, and all their leaders gave him rods, one for each leader, according to their ancestral houses, even 12 rods, And the rod of Aaron was among their rods. Moses laid up the rods before the Lord in the tent of the testimony. It happened on the next day, that Moses went into the tent of the testimony, and look, the rod of Aaron for the house of Levi was budded, and put forth buds, and produced blossoms, and bore ripe almonds. Moses brought out all the rods from before the Lord to all the children of Israel, and they looked, and took every man his rod. The Lord said to Moses, "Put back the rod of Aaron before the testimony, to be kept for a token against the children of rebellion, that you may make an end of their murmurings against me, that they not die." Moses did so. As the Lord commanded him, so he did. The children of Israel spoke to Moses, saying, "Look, we perish. We are undone. We are all undone. Everyone who comes near to the tabernacle of the Lord, dies. Will we all perish?" Chapter 18. The Lord said to Aaron, "You and your sons and your father's house with you shall bear the iniquity of the sanctuary, and you and your sons with you shall bear the iniquity of your priesthood. Your brothers also, the tribe of Levi, the tribe of your father, bring near with you, that they may be joined to you, and minister to you, but you and your sons with you shall be before the tent of the testimony. They shall keep your commands, and the duty of all the tent, only they shall not come near to the vessels of the sanctuary and to the altar, that they not die, neither they, nor you. They shall be joined to you, and keep the responsibility of the tent of meeting, for all the service of the tent, and a stranger shall not come near to you. You shall perform the duty of the sanctuary, and the duty of the altar, that there be no more wrath on the children of Israel. And as for me, look, I have taken your brothers the Levites from among the sons of Israel, they are a gift to you, given to the Lord, to do the service of the tent of meeting. You and your sons with you shall keep your priesthood for everything concerning the altar, and for that inside the veil, and you shall serve. I give you the priesthood as a service of gift, and the stranger who comes near shall be put to death." The Lord spoke to Aaron, "Look, I have given you the command of my wave offerings, even all the holy things of the children of Israel, to you have I given them by reason of the anointing, and to your sons, as a portion forever. This shall be yours of the most holy things from the fire, every offering of theirs, even every meal offering of theirs, and every sin offering of theirs, and every trespass offering of theirs, which they shall render to me, shall be most holy for you and for your sons. You shall eat of it like the most holy things. Every male shall eat of it. It shall be holy to you. This is yours, too, the wave offering of their gift, even all the wave offerings of the children of Israel. I have given them to you, and to your sons and to your daughters with you, as a portion forever. Everyone who is clean in your house shall eat of it. All the best of the oil, and all the best of the vintage, and of the grain, the first fruits of them which they give to the Lord, to you have I given them. The first ripe fruits of all that is in their land, which they bring to the Lord, shall be yours. Everyone who is clean in your house shall eat of it. Everything devoted in Israel shall be yours. Everything that opens the womb, of all flesh which they offer to the Lord, both of man and animal shall be yours. Nevertheless you shall surely redeem the firstborn of man, and you shall redeem the firstborn of unclean animals. You shall redeem those who are to be redeemed of them from a month old, according to your estimation, for 5 shekels of money, after the shekel of the sanctuary, which is 20 gerahs. But you shall not redeem the firstborn of a cow, or the firstborn of a sheep, or the firstborn of a goat. They are holy. You shall sprinkle their blood on the altar, and shall burn their fat for an offering made by fire, for a pleasant aroma to the Lord. Their flesh shall be yours, as the wave offering breast and as the right thigh, it shall be yours. All the wave offerings of the holy things, which the children of Israel offer to the Lord, have I given you, and your sons and your daughters with you, as a portion forever. It is a covenant of salt forever before the Lord to you and to your descendants with you." The Lord said to Aaron, "You shall have no inheritance in their land, neither shall you have any portion among them. I am your portion and your inheritance among the children of Israel." To the children of Levi, "Look, I have given all the tithe in Israel for an inheritance, in return for their service which they serve, even the service of the tent of meeting. Hereafter the children of Israel shall not come near the tent of meeting, lest they bear sin, and die. But the Levites shall do the service of the tent of meeting, and they shall bear their iniquity. It shall be a statute forever throughout your generations, and among the children of Israel they shall have no inheritance. For the tithe of the children of Israel, which they offer as a wave offering to the Lord, I have given to the Levites for an inheritance. Therefore I have said to them, among the children of Israel they shall have no inheritance." The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Moreover, you shall speak to the Levites, and tell them, when you take of the children of Israel the tithe which I have given you from them for your inheritance, then you shall offer up a wave offering of it for the Lord, a tithe of the tithe. Your wave offering shall be reckoned to you, as though it were the grain of the threshing floor, and as the fullness of the winepress. Thus you also shall offer a wave offering to the Lord of all your tithes, which you receive of the children of Israel, and of it you shall give the Lord's wave offering to Aaron the priest. Out of all your gifts you shall offer every wave offering of the Lord, of all its best, even the holy part of it out of it. Therefore you shall tell them, when you heave its best from it, then it shall be reckoned to the Levites as the increase of the threshing floor, and as the increase of the winepress. You shall eat it in every place, you and your households, for it is your reward in return for your service in the tent of meeting. You shall bear no sin by reason of it, when you have heaved from it its best, and you shall not profane the holy things of the children of Israel, that you not die. Chapter 19. The Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, saying, this is the statute of the law which the Lord has commanded, speak to the children of Israel, that they bring you a red heifer without spot, in which is no blemish, and which was never yoked. And you shall give it to Eleazar the priest, and they shall bring it outside of the camp, and they shall slaughter it in his presence. And Eleazar the priest shall take of its blood with his finger, and sprinkle this blood toward the front of the tent of meeting 7 times. Then he shall burn the heifer in his sight, its skin, and its flesh, and its blood, with its dung, he shall burn. And the priest shall take cedar wood, and hyssop, and scarlet, and cast it into the midst of the burning of the heifer. Then the priest shall wash his clothes, and he shall bathe his flesh in water, and afterward he shall come into the camp, and the priest shall be unclean until the evening. He who burns her shall wash his clothes in water, and bathe his flesh in water, and shall be unclean until the evening. A man who is clean shall gather up the ashes of the heifer, and lay them up outside of the camp in a clean place, and it shall be kept for the congregation of the children of Israel for a water for impurity. It is a sin offering. He who gathers the ashes of the heifer shall wash his clothes, and be unclean until the evening, and it shall be to the children of Israel, and to the stranger who lives as a foreigner among them, for a statute forever. He who touches the dead body of any man shall be unclean 7 days, the same shall purify himself with water on the 3rd day, and on the 7th day he shall be clean, but if he doesn't purify himself the 3rd day, then the 7th day he shall not be clean. Whoever touches a dead person, the body of a man who has died, and doesn't purify himself, defiles the tabernacle of the Lord, and that soul shall be cut off from Israel, because the water for impurity was not sprinkled on him, he shall be unclean, his uncleanness is yet on him. This is the law when a man dies in a tent, everyone who comes into the tent, and everyone who is in the tent, shall be unclean 7 days. Every open vessel, which has no covering bound on it, is unclean. Whoever in the open field touches one who is slain with a sword, or a dead body, or a bone of a man, or a grave, shall be unclean 7 days. For the unclean they shall take of the ashes of the burning of the sin offering, and running water shall be put thereto in a vessel, and a clean person shall take hyssop, and dip it in the water, and sprinkle it on the tent, and on all the vessels, and on the persons who were there, and on him who touched the bone, or the slain, or the dead, or the grave. And the clean person shall sprinkle on the unclean on the 3rd day, and on the 7th day, and on the 7th day he shall purify him, and he shall wash his clothes, and bathe himself in water, and shall be clean at evening. But the man who shall be unclean, and shall not purify himself, that soul shall be cut off from the midst of the assembly, because he has defiled the sanctuary of the Lord, the water for impurity has not been sprinkled on him, he is unclean. It shall be a perpetual statute to them. And he who sprinkles the water for impurity shall wash his clothes, and he who touches the water for impurity shall be unclean until evening. Whatever the unclean person touches shall be unclean, and the soul that touches it shall be unclean until evening. Chapter 20. The children of Israel, even the whole congregation, came into the wilderness of Zin in the 1st month, and the people stayed in Kadesh, and Miriam died there, and was buried there. There was no water for the congregation, and they assembled themselves together against Moses and against Aaron. The people strove with Moses, and spoke, saying, we wish that we had died when our brothers died before the Lord. Why have you brought the assembly of the Lord into this wilderness, that we should die there, we and our animals? Why have you made us to come up out of Egypt, to bring us into this evil place? It is no place of seed, or of figs, or of vines, or of pomegranates, neither is there any water to drink. Moses and Aaron went from the presence of the assembly to the door of the tent of meeting, and fell on their faces, and the glory of the Lord appeared to them. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Take the rod, and assemble the congregation, you, and Aaron your brother, and speak to the rock before their eyes, that it give forth its water, and you shall bring forth to them water out of the rock, so you shall give the congregation and their livestock drink. Moses took the rod from before the Lord, as he commanded him. Moses and Aaron gathered the assembly together before the rock, and he said to them, Hear now, you rebels, shall we bring you water out of this rock for you? Moses lifted up his hand, and struck the rock with his rod twice, and water came forth abundantly, and the congregation drank, and their livestock. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, Because you did not believe in me, to sanctify me in the eyes of the children of Israel, therefore you shall not bring this assembly into the land which I have given them. These are the waters of Meribah, because the children of Israel strove with the Lord, and he was sanctified in them. Moses sent messengers from Kadesh to the king of Edom, saying, Thus says your brother Israel, you know all the travail that has happened to us, how our fathers went down into Egypt, and we lived in Egypt a long time, and the Egyptians dealt ill with us, and our fathers, and when we cried to the Lord, he heard our voice, and sent an angel, and brought us forth out of Egypt, and look, we are in Kadesh, a city in the uttermost of your border. Please let us pass through your land. We will not pass through field or through vineyard, neither will we drink of the water of the wells. We will go along the king's highway. We will not turn aside to the right hand nor to the left, until we have passed your border. Edom said to him, You shall not pass through me, lest I come out with the sword against you. The children of Israel said to him, We will go up by the highway, and if we drink of your water, I and my livestock, then will I give its price. Let me only, without doing anything else, pass through on my feet. He said, You shall not pass through. Edom came out against him with many people, and with a strong hand. Thus Edom refused to give Israel passage through his border, so Israel turned away from him. They traveled from Kadesh, and the children of Israel, even the whole congregation, came to Mount Hor. The Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron in Mount Hor, by the border of the land of Edom, saying, Aaron shall be gathered to his people, for he shall not enter into the land which I have given to the children of Israel, because you rebelled against my word at the waters of Meribah. Take Aaron and Eleazar his son, and bring them up to Mount Hor, and strip Aaron of his garments, and put them on Eleazar his son, and Aaron shall be taken, and shall die there. Moses did as the Lord commanded, and they went up into Mount Hor in the sight of all the congregation. Moses stripped Aaron of his garments, and put them on Eleazar his son, and Aaron died there on the top of the mountain, and Moses and Eleazar came down from the mountain. When all the congregation saw that Aaron was dead, they wept for Aaron 30 days, even all the house of Israel. Chapter 21. When the Canaanite king Evrod who lived in the Negev heard that Israel came by the way of Athram, then he fought against Israel, and took some of them captive. Israel vowed a vow to the Lord, and said, If you will indeed deliver this people into my hand, then I will utterly destroy their cities. The Lord listened to the voice of Israel, and delivered up the Canaanites, and they utterly destroyed them and their cities, and the name of the place was called Hormah. They traveled from Mount Hor by the way to the Sea of Suf, to compass the land of Edom, and the soul of the people was much discouraged because of the way. The people spoke against God, and against Moses, Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, and there is no water, and our soul loathes this light bread. The Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and many people of Israel died. The people came to Moses, and said, We have sinned, because we have spoken against the Lord, and against you. Pray to the Lord, that he take away the serpents from us. Moses prayed for the people. The Lord said to Moses, Make a fiery serpent, and set it on a standard, and it shall happen, that everyone who is bitten, when he sees it, shall live. Moses made a serpent of bronze, and set it on the standard, and it happened, that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he looked to the serpent of bronze, he lived. The children of Israel traveled, and camped in Oboth. They traveled from Oboth, and camped at Ea-Abarim, in the wilderness which is before Moab, toward the sunrise. From there they traveled, and camped in the valley of Zered. From there they traveled, and camped on the other side of the Arnon, which is in the wilderness, that comes out of the border of the Amorites, for the Arnon is the border of Moab, between Moab and the Amorites. Therefore it is said in the book of the wars of the Lord, Waheb and Sufa, The valleys of the Arnon, the slope of the valleys that incline toward the dwelling of Ar, leans on the border of Moab. From there they traveled to Beer, that is the well of which the Lord said to Moses, "Gather the people together, and I will give them water." Then sang Israel this song, "Spring up, well, sing to it, the well, which the princes dug, which the nobles of the people dug, with the scepter, and with their staffs." From the wilderness they traveled to Madinah, and from Madinah to Nahaliel, and from Nahaliel to Bamoth, and from Bamoth to the valley that is in the field of Moab, to the top of Pisgah, which looks down on the desert. Israel sent messengers to Sihon king of the Amorites, saying, "Let me pass through your land, we will not turn aside into field, or into vineyard, we will not drink of the water of the wells, we will go by the king's highway, until we have passed your border." Sihon would not allow Israel to pass through his border, but Sihon gathered all his people together, and went out against Israel into the wilderness, and came to Jahaz, and he fought against Israel. Israel struck him with the edge of the sword, and possessed his land from the Arnon to the Jabbok, even to the children of Ammon, for the border of the children of Ammon was strong. Israel took all these cities, and Israel lived in all the cities of the Amorites, in Heshbon, and in all its towns. For Heshbon was the city of Sihon the king of the Amorites, who had fought against the former king of Moab, and taken all his land out of his hand, even to the Arnon. Therefore those who speak in Proverbs say, "Come to Heshbon, let the city of Sihon be built and established, for a fire has gone out of Heshbon, a flame from the city of Sihon. It has devoured Ar of Moab, swallowed up the high places of the Arnon. What to you, Moab? You are undone, people of Chemosh. He has given his sons as fugitives, and his daughters into captivity, to Sihon king of the Amorites. And we shot at them. Heshbon has perished as far as Dibon. And we have laid waste as far as Nopha, which reaches to Medeba." Thus Israel lived in the land of the Amorites. Moses sent to spy out Jazer, and they took its towns, and drove out the Amorites who were there. They turned and went up by the way of Bashan, and Og the king of Bashan went out against them, he and all his people, to battle at Edrei. The Lord said to Moses, "Do not fear him, for I have delivered him into your hand, and all his people, and his land, and you shall do to him as you did to Sihon king of the Amorites, who lived at Heshbon." So they struck him, and his sons and all his people, until there was none left him remaining, and they possessed his land. Chapter 22. The children of Israel traveled, and camped in the plains of Moab beyond the Jordan at Jericho. Balak the son of Zippor saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites. Moab was very afraid of the people, because they were many, and Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel. Moab said to the elders of Midian, "Now this multitude will lick up all that is around us, as the ox licks up the grass of the field." Balak the son of Zippor was king of Moab at that time. He sent messengers to Balaam the son of Beor, to Pethor, which is by the river, to the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying, "Look, there is a people who came out from Egypt. Look, they cover the surface of the earth, and they are staying opposite me. And now please come, curse this people for me, for they are too mighty for me. Perhaps I shall prevail, that we may strike them, and that I may drive them out of the land, for I know that he whom you bless is blessed, and he whom you curse is cursed." The elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the fees for divination in their hand, and they came to Balaam, and spoke to him the words of Balak. And he said to them, "Lodge here this night, and I will bring you word again, as YHWH shall speak to me." The princes of Moab stayed with Balaam. And God came to Balaam, and said, "Who are these men with you?" And Balaam said to God, "Balak the son of Zippor, king of Moab, has sent to me, saying, 'Look, this people has come out of Egypt and they cover the surface of the earth. Come now, curse them for me, perhaps I shall be able to fight against them, and shall drive them out.'" And God said to Balaam, "You are not to go with them, and you are not to curse the people, for they are blessed." And Balaam rose up in the morning, and said to the princes of Balak, "Go to your lord, for God refuses to permit me to go with you." The princes of Moab rose up, and they went to Balak, and said, "Balaam refuses to come with us." Then Balak again sent princes, more in number and more honorable than these. They came to Balaam, and said to him, "Thus says Balak the son of Zippor, please let nothing hinder you from coming to me, for I will greatly honor you, and whatever you say to me I will do for you. Please come therefore, and curse this people for me." Balaam answered the servants of Balak, "If Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I can't go beyond the command of YHWH my God, to do less or more. Now therefore, you also stay here tonight, that I may know what else YHWH will say to me." God came to Balaam at night, and said to him, "If the men have come to call you, rise up, go with them, but only the word which I speak to you, that you shall do." Balaam rose up in the morning, and saddled his donkey, and went with the princes of Moab. God's anger was kindled because he went, and the angel of YHWH placed himself in the way for an adversary against him. Now he was riding on his donkey, and his two servants were with him. The donkey saw the angel of God standing in the way, with his sword drawn in his hand, and the donkey turned aside out of the way, and went into the field, and Balaam struck the donkey, to turn her into the way. Then the angel of God stood in a narrow path between the vineyards, a wall being on this side, and a wall on that side. The donkey saw the angel of God, and she thrust herself to the wall, and crushed Balaam's foot against the wall, and he struck her again. The angel of God went further, and stood in a narrow place, where there was no way to turn either to the right hand or to the left. The donkey saw the angel of God, and she lay down under Balaam, and Balaam's anger was kindled, and he struck the donkey with his staff. And God opened the mouth of the donkey, and she said to Balaam, "What have I done to you, that you have struck me these three times?" Balaam said to the donkey, "Because you have mocked me, I wish there were a sword in my hand, for now I would have killed you." The donkey said to Balaam, "Am I not your donkey, on which you have ridden all your life long to this day? Was I ever in the habit of doing so to you?" He said, "No." Then God opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of God standing in the way, with his sword drawn in his hand, and he bowed his head, and fell on his face. The angel of God said to him, "Why have you struck your donkey these three times? Look, I have come forth as an adversary, because your way is perverse before me," and the donkey saw me, and turned aside before me these three times. Unless she had turned aside from me, surely now I would have killed you, and saved her alive. Balaam said to the angel of the Lord, "I have sinned, for I did not know that you stood in the way against me. Now therefore, if it displeases you, I will go back again." The angel of God said to Balaam, "Go with the men, but only the word that I shall speak to you, that you shall speak." So Balaam went with the princes of Balak. When Balak heard that Balaam had come, he went out to meet him to the city of Moab, which is on the border of the Arnon, which is in the utmost part of the border. Balak said to Balaam, "Did I not earnestly send to you to call you? Why did you not come to me? Am I not able indeed to promote you to honor?" Balaam said to Balak, "Look, I have come to you, have I now any power at all to speak anything? The word that God puts in my mouth, that shall I speak." Balaam went with Balak, and they came to Kiriath-huzoth. Balak sacrificed cattle and sheep, and sent to Balaam, and to the princes who were with him. It happened in the morning, that Balak took Balaam, and brought him up into the high places of Baal, and he saw from there the utmost part of the people. Chapter 23. Balaam said to Balak, "Build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 bulls and 7 rams." Balak did as Balaam had spoken, and Balak and Balaam offered on every altar a bull and a ram. Balaam said to Balak, "Station yourself by your burnt offering, and I will go. Perhaps God will come to meet me, and whatever he shows me I will tell you." And Balak went off and stationed himself by his offering, and Balaam called to God and went off to a barren height. And God met Balaam, and he said to him, "I have prepared the 7 altars, and I have offered up a bull and a ram on every altar." And God put a word in Balaam's mouth, and said, "Return to Balak, and thus you shall speak." He returned to him, and look, he was standing by his burnt offering, he, and all the princes of Moab. He took up his parable, and said, "From Aram has Balak brought me, the king of Moab from the mountains of the east. Come, curse Jacob for me. Come, defy Israel. How shall I curse whom the Lord has not cursed? How shall I defy whom God has not defied? For from the top of the rocks I see him. From the hills I see him. Look, it is a people that dwells alone, and not counting itself among the nations. Who can count the dust of Jacob, and who has numbered the fourth part of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous. Let my last end be like his." Balak said to Balaam, "What have you done to me? I took you to curse my enemies, and look, you have blessed them altogether." He answered and said, "Must I not be careful to speak that which God puts in my mouth?" Balak said to him, Please come with me to another place, where you may see them. You shall see but the utmost part of them, and shall not see them all, and curse them for me from there. He took him into the field of Zophim, to the top of Pisgah, and built 7 altars, and offered up a bull and a ram on every altar. He said to Balak, "Station yourself here by your burnt offering, while I meet over there." And God met Balaam and put a word in his mouth, and said, "Return to Balak, and say this." He came to him, and look, he was standing by his burnt offering, and the princes of Moab with him. Balak said to him, "What has the Lord spoken?" He took up his parable, and said, "Rise up, Balak, and hear. Listen to me, you son of Zippor. God is not a man, that he should lie, nor the son of man, that he should repent. Has he said, and will he not do it? Or has he spoken, and will he not make it good? Look, I have received a command to bless. He has blessed, and I can't reverse it. He has not seen iniquity in Jacob. Neither has he seen perverseness in Israel. The Lord his God is with him. The shout of a king is among them. God brings them out of Egypt. He has as it were the strength of the wild ox. Surely there is no enchantment with Jacob, neither is there any divination with Israel. Now it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what has God done? Look, the people rises up as a lioness, as a lion he lifts himself up. He shall not lie down until he eat of the prey, and drinks the blood of the slain." Balak said to Balaam, "Neither curse them at all, nor bless them at all." But Balaam answered Balak, "Did I not tell you, saying, all that God speaks, that I must do?" Balak said to Balaam, "Come now, I will take you to another place, perhaps it will please God that you may curse them for me from there." Balak took Balaam to the top of Peor, that looks down on the desert. Balaam said to Balak, "Build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 bulls and 7 rams." Balak did as Balaam had said, and offered up a bull and a ram on every altar. Chapter 24. When Balaam saw that it pleased the Lord to bless Israel, he did not go, as at the other times, to meet with omens, but he set his face toward the wilderness. Balaam lifted up his eyes, and he saw Israel dwelling according to their tribes, and the Spirit of God came on him. He took up his parable, and said, "Balaam the son of Beor says, the man whose eye was closed says, he says, who hears the words of God, who sees the vision of Shaddai, falling down, and having his eyes open, how goodly are your tents, Jacob, and your tents, Israel. As valleys they are spread forth, as gardens by the riverside, as aloes which the Lord has planted, as cedar trees beside the waters. Water shall flow from his buckets. His seed shall be in many waters. His king shall be higher than Agag. His kingdom shall be exalted. God brings him out of Egypt. He has as it were the strength of the wild ox. He shall eat up the nations his adversaries, shall break their bones in pieces, and pierce them with his arrows. He couched, he lay down as a lion, as a lioness, who shall rouse him up? Everyone who blesses you is blessed. Everyone who curses you is cursed." Balak's anger was kindled against Balaam, and he struck his hands together, and Balak said to Balaam, "I called you to curse my enemies, and, look, you have altogether blessed them these 3 times. Therefore now flee you to your place. I thought to promote you to great honor, but, look, the Lord has kept you back from honor." Balaam said to Balak, "Did I not also tell your messengers who you sent to me, saying, if Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I can't go beyond the word of the Lord, to do either good or bad in my heart, I will say what God says? Now, look, I go to my people, come, I will inform you what this people shall do to your people in the latter days." He took up his parable, and said, "Balaam the son of Beor says, the man whose eye was closed says, he says, who hears the words of God, knows the knowledge of the Most High, and who sees the vision of Shaddai, falling down, and having his eyes open, I see him, but not now. I see him, but not near. A star will come out of Jacob. A scepter will rise out of Israel, and will crush the forehead of Moab, and the crown of all the sons of tumult. Edom shall be a possession. Seir, his enemies, also shall be a possession, while Israel does valiantly. Out of Jacob shall one have dominion, and shall destroy the remnant from the city." He looked at Amalek, and took up his parable, and said, "Amalek was the first of the nations, but his latter end shall come to destruction." He looked at the Kenite, and took up his parable, and said, "Your dwelling place is strong. Your nest is set in the rock. Nevertheless Cain shall be wasted, until Ashur carries you away captive. He took up his parable, and said, Alas, who shall live when God does this? But ships shall come from the coast of Kittim. They shall afflict Ashur, and shall afflict Eber. He also shall come to destruction. Balaam rose up, and went and returned to his place, and Balak also went his way. Chapter 25. Now Israel stayed in Shittim, and the people defiled themselves by having sexual relations with the women of Moab, and they called the people to the sacrifices of their gods, and the people ate, and bowed down to their gods. Israel joined himself to Baal Peor, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against Israel. The Lord said to Moses, Take all the chiefs of the people, and hang them up to the Lord before the sun, that the fierce anger of the Lord may turn away from Israel. Moses said to the judges of Israel, Everyone kill his men who have joined themselves to Baal Peor. Look, one of the children of Israel came and brought to his brothers a Midianite woman in the sight of Moses, and in the sight of all the congregation of the children of Israel, while they were weeping at the door of the tent of meeting. When Phinehas, the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron the priest, saw it, he rose up from the midst of the congregation, and took a spear in his hand, and he went after the man of Israel into the pavilion, and thrust both of them through, the man of Israel, and the woman through her body. So the plague was stayed from the children of Israel. Those who died by the plague were 24,000. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Phinehas, the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron the priest, has turned my wrath away from the children of Israel, in that he was jealous with my jealousy among them, so that I did not consume the children of Israel in my jealousy. Therefore say, Look, I give to him my covenant of peace, and it shall be to him, and to his descendants after him, the covenant of an everlasting priesthood, because he was jealous for his God, and made atonement for the children of Israel. Now the name of the man of Israel that was slain, who was slain with the Midianite woman, was Zimri, the son of Salu, a prince of a father's house among the Simeonites. The name of the Midianite woman who was slain was Cosbi, the daughter of Zur. He was head of the people of a father's house in Midian. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, saying, Harass the Midianites, and strike them, for they harassed you with their tricks, with which they have deceived you in the matter of Peor, and in the matter of Cosbi, the daughter of the prince of Midian, their sister, who was slain on the day of the plague in the matter of Peor. Chapter 26. It happened after the plague, that the Lord spoke to Moses and to Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest, saying, Take a census of all the congregation of the children of Israel, from 20 years old and upward, by their fathers' houses, all who are able to go forth to war in Israel. Moses and Eleazar the priest spoke with them in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho, saying, Take a census, from 20 years old and upward, as the Lord commanded Moses and the children of Israel. These are those that came out of the land of Egypt. Reuben, the firstborn of Israel, the sons of Reuben, of Hanok, the family of the Hanokites, of Palu, the family of the Paluites, of Hezron, the family of the Hezronites, of Carmi, the family of the Carmites. These are the families of the Reubenites, and those who were numbered of them were 43,730. The sons of Palu, Eliab. The sons of Eliab, Nemuel, and Dathan, and Abiram. These are that Dathan and Abiram, who were called of the congregation, who strove against Moses and against Aaron in the company of Korah, when they strove against the Lord, and the earth opened its mouth, and swallowed them up together with Korah, when that company died, what time the fire devoured 250 men, and they became a sign. Notwithstanding, the sons of Korah did not die. The sons of Simeon after their families, of Jemuel, the family of the Jemuelites, of Jamon, the family of the Jamonites, of Jachin, the family of the Jachinites, of Zohar, the family of the Zoharites, of Shaul, the family of the Shaulites. These are the families of the Simeonites, 22,200. The sons of Gad after their families, of Zephon, the family of the Zephonites, of Haggi, the family of the Haggites, of Shunai, the family of the Shunites, of Esben, the family of the Esbenites, of Eri, the family of the Erites, of Erodi, the family of the Erodites, of Areli, the family of the Erlites. These are the families of the sons of Gad according to those who are numbered of them, 40,500. The sons of Judah, Ur-and-Onan, and Ur-and-Onan died in the land of Canaan. The sons of Judah after their families were, of Shelah, the family of the Shelonites, of Perez, the family of the Perezites, of Zerah, the family of the Zerahites. The sons of Perez were, of Hezron, the family of the Hezronites, of Hamul, the family of the Hamulites, These are the families of Judah according to those who are numbered of them, 76,500. The sons of Issachar after their families, of Tola, the family of the Tolaites, of Pua, the family of the Puites, of Jashub, the family of the Jashubites, of Shimron, the family of the Shimronites. These are the families of Issachar according to those who are numbered of them, 64,300. The sons of Zebulun after their families, of Serek, the family of the Seredites, of Elon, the family of the Elonites, of Jaleel, the family of the Jaleelites. These are the families of the Zebulunites according to those who are numbered of them, 60,500. The sons of Joseph after their families, Manasseh and Ephraim. The sons of Manasseh, of Machir, the family of the Machirites, and Machir became the father of Gilead, the family of the Gileadites. These are the sons of Gilead, of Abiezer, the family of the Abiezerites, of Helek, the family of the Helekites, and Azrael, the family of the Asrielites, and Shechem, the family of the Shechemites, and Shemida, the family of the Shemidites, and Hepher, the family of the Hepherites. Zelophehad the son of Hepher had no sons, but daughters, and these are the names of the daughters of Zelophehad, Mahlah, and Noah, Hoglah, Milcah, and Tirzah. These are the families of Manasseh, and those who were numbered of them were 52,700. These are the sons of Ephraim after their families, of Shuthelah, the family of the Shuthelahites, of Becher, the family of the Becherites, of Tahan, the family of the Tahanites. These are the sons of Shuthelah, of Eden, the family of the Edenites. These are the families of the sons of Ephraim according to those who are numbered of them, 32,500. These are the sons of Joseph after their families. The sons of Benjamin after their families, of Bela, the family of the Belites, of Ashbel, the family of the Ashbelites, of Ahiram, the family of the Ahiramites, of Shupim, the family of the Shupimites, of Huppim, the family of the Huppimites. The sons of Bela were Ard and Naaman, of Ard, the family of the Ardites, of Naaman, the family of the Naamanites. These are the sons of Benjamin after their families, and those who were numbered of them were 45,600. These are the sons of Dan after their families, of Shuham, the family of the Shuhamites. These are the families of Dan after their families. All the families of the Shuhamites, according to those who were numbered of them, were 64,400. The sons of Asher after their families, of Jimna, the family of the Jimna, of Jishvi, the family of the Jishvites, of Beriah, the family of the Berites. Of the sons of Beriah, of Heber, the family of the Heberites, of Malkiel, the family of the Malkielites. The name of the daughter of Asher was Sarah. These are the families of the sons of Asher according to those who are numbered of them, 53,400. The sons of Naphtali after their families, of Jahziel, the family of the Jahzielites, of Guni, the family of the Gunites, of Jezer, the family of the Jezerites, of Shillem, the family of the Shillemites. These are the families of Naphtali according to their families, and those who were numbered of them were 45,400. These are those who were numbered of the children of Israel, 601,730. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "To these the land shall be divided for an inheritance according to the number of names. To the more you shall give the more inheritance, and to the fewer you shall give the less inheritance, to everyone according to those who are numbered of him shall his inheritance be given. Notwithstanding, the land shall be divided by lot, according to the names of the tribes of their fathers they shall inherit. According to the lot shall their inheritance be divided between the more and the fewer." These are those who are numbered of the Levites after their families, of Gershon, the family of the Gershonites, of Kohath, the family of the Kohathites, of Merari, the family of the Merarites. These are the families of Levi, the family of the Libnites, the family of the Hebronites, the family of the Malites, the family of the Mushites, the family of the Korahites. Kohath became the father of Amram. The name of Amram's wife was Jochebed, the daughter of Levi, who was born to Levi in Egypt, and she bore to Amram Aaron and Moses, and Miriam their sister. To Aaron were born Nadab and Abihu, Eleazar and Itamar. Nadab and Abihu died when they offered strange fire before the Lord. Those who were numbered of them were 23,000, every male from a month old and upward, for they were not numbered among the children of Israel, because there was no inheritance given them among the children of Israel. These are those who were numbered by Moses and Eleazar the priest, who numbered the children of Israel in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho. But among these there was not a man of them who were numbered by Moses and Aaron the priest, who numbered the children of Israel in the wilderness of Sinai. For the Lord had said of them, They shall surely die in the wilderness. There was not left a man of them, except Caleb the son of Jephunneh, and Joshua the son of Nun. Chapter 27. Then drew near the daughters of Zelophehad, the son of Hepher, the son of Gilead, the son of Machir, the son of Manasseh, of the families of Manasseh the son of Joseph, and these are the names of his daughters, Mahlah, Noah, and Hoglah, and Milcah, and Tirzah. They stood before Moses, and before Eleazar the priest, and before the princes and all the congregation, at the door of the tent of meeting, saying, Our father died in the wilderness, and he was not among the company of those who gathered themselves together against the Lord in the company of Korah, but he died in his own sin, and he had no sons. Why should the name of our father be taken away from among his family, because he had no son? Give to us a possession among the brothers of our father. Moses brought their cause before the Lord. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, The daughters of Zelophehad speak right. You shall surely give them a possession of an inheritance among their father's brothers, and you shall cause the inheritance of their father to pass to them. You shall speak to the children of Israel, saying, If a man dies, and has no son, then you shall cause his inheritance to pass to his daughter. If he has no daughter, then you shall give his inheritance to his brothers. If he has no brothers, then you shall give his inheritance to his father's brothers. If his father has no brothers, then you shall give his inheritance to his kinsman who is next to him of his family, and he shall possess it, and it shall be to the children of Israel a statute and ordinance, as the Lord commanded Moses. The Lord said to Moses, Go up into this mountain of Abarim, and see the land which I have given to the children of Israel. When you have seen it, you also shall be gathered to your people, as Aaron your brother was gathered, because you rebelled against my word in the wilderness of Zin, in the strife of the congregation, to sanctify me at the waters before their eyes. These are the waters of Meribah of Kadesh in the wilderness of Zin. Moses spoke to the Lord, saying, Let the Lord, the God of the spirits of all flesh, appoint a man over the congregation, who may go out before them, and who may come in before them, and who may lead them out, and who may bring them in, that the congregation of the Lord not be a sheep which have no shepherd. The Lord said to Moses, Take Joshua the son of Nun, a man in whom is the Spirit, and lay your hand on him, and set him before Eleazar the priest, and before all the congregation, and commission him in their sight. You shall put of your honor on him, that all the congregation of the children of Israel may obey. He shall stand before Eleazar the priest, who shall inquire for him by the judgment of the Urim before the Lord, at his word shall they go out, and at his word they shall come in, both he, and all the children of Israel with him, even all the congregation. Moses did as the Lord commanded him. And he took Joshua, and set him before Eleazar the priest, and before all the congregation, and he laid his hands on him, and commissioned him, as the Lord spoke by Moses. Chapter 28. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Command the children of Israel, and tell them, My offering, my food for my offerings made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to me, you shall observe to offer to me in their due season. You shall tell them, This is the offering made by fire which you shall offer to the Lord, male lambs a year old without blemish, 2 days by day, for a continual burnt offering. You shall offer the one lamb in the morning, and you shall offer the other lamb at evening, with a tenth part of an ephah of fine flour for a meal offering, mixed with the fourth part of a hin of beaten oil. It is a continual burnt offering, which was ordained in Mount Sinai for a pleasant aroma, an offering made by fire to the Lord. Its drink offering shall be the fourth part of a hin for the one lamb. You shall pour out a drink offering of strong drink to the Lord in the holy place. The other lamb you shall offer at evening, as the meal offering of the morning, and as the drink offering of it, you shall offer it, an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord. On the Sabbath day 2 male lambs a year old without blemish, and 2/10 parts of an ephah of fine flour for a meal offering, mixed with oil, and the drink offering of it. This is the burnt offering of every Sabbath, besides the continual burnt offering, and the drink offering of it. In the beginnings of your months you shall offer a burnt offering to the Lord, 2 young bulls, and 1 ram, 7 male lambs a year old without blemish, and 3/10 parts of an ephah of fine flour for a meal offering, mixed with oil, for each bull, and 2/10 parts of fine flour for a meal offering, mixed with oil, for the 1 ram. And 1/10 part of fine flour mixed with oil for a meal offering to every lamb, for a burnt offering of a pleasant aroma, an offering made by fire to the Lord. Their drink offerings shall be 1/2 a hin of wine for a bull, and 1/3 part of a hin for the ram, And the fourth part of a hin for a lamb, this is the burnt offering of every month throughout the months of the year. One male goat for a sin offering to the Lord, it shall be offered besides the continual burnt offering, and the drink offering of it. In the first month, on the 14th day of the month, is the Lord's Passover. On the 15th day of this month shall be a feast, 7 days shall unleavened bread be eaten. In the first day shall be a holy convocation, you shall do no servile work, but you shall offer an offering made by fire, a burnt offering to the Lord, 2 young bulls, and 1 ram, and 7 male lambs a year old, they shall be to you without blemish, and their meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, you shall offer 3/10 parts for a bull, and 2/10 parts for the ram. You shall offer 1/10 part for every lamb of the 7 lambs, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, to make atonement for you. You shall offer these besides the burnt offering of the morning, which is for a continual burnt offering. In this way you shall offer daily, for 7 days, the food of the offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord, it shall be offered besides the continual burnt offering, and the drink offering of it. On the 7th day you shall have a holy convocation, you shall do no servile work. Also in the day of the first fruits, when you offer a new meal offering to the Lord in your feast of weeks, you shall have a holy convocation, you shall do no servile work, but you shall offer a burnt offering for a pleasant aroma to the Lord, 2 young bulls, 1 ram, 7 male lambs a year old, and their meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, 3/10 parts for each bull, 2/10 parts for the 1 ram, 1/10 part for every lamb of the 7 lambs, 1 male goat, to make atonement for you. Besides the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, you shall offer them, they shall be to you without blemish, and their drink offerings. Chapter 29. In the 7th month, on the 1st day of the month, you shall have a holy convocation, you shall do no servile work, it is a day of blowing of trumpets to you. You shall offer a burnt offering for a pleasant aroma to the Lord, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 7 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, 3/10 parts for the bull, 2/10 parts for the ram, and 1/10 part for every lamb of the 7 lambs, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, to make atonement for you, besides the burnt offering of the new moon, and the meal offering of it, and the continual burnt offering and the meal offering of it, and their drink offerings, according to their ordinance, for a pleasant aroma, an offering made by fire to the Lord. On the 10th day of this 7th month you shall have a holy convocation, and you shall afflict your souls, you shall do no kind of work, but you shall offer a burnt offering to the Lord for a pleasant aroma, 1 young bull, 1 ram, 7 male lambs a year old, they shall be to you without blemish, and their meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, 3/10 parts for the bull, 2/10 parts for the 1 ram, 1/10 part for every lamb of the 7 lambs, 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the sin offering of atonement, and the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, and their drink offerings. On the 15th day of the 7th month you shall have a holy convocation, you shall do no servile work, and you shall keep a feast to the Lord 7 days, and you shall offer a burnt offering, an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord, 13 young bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old, they shall be without blemish, and their meal offering, fine flour mixed with oil, 3/10 parts for every bull of the 13 bulls, 2/10 parts for each ram of the 2 rams, and 1/10 part for every lamb of the 14 lambs, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. On the 2nd day you shall offer 12 young bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, and their drink offerings. On the 3rd day 11 bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. On the 4th day 10 bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. On the fifth day 9 bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. On the sixth day 8 bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, the meal offering of it, and the drink offerings of it. On the seventh day 7 bulls, 2 rams, 14 male lambs a year old without blemish, and their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bulls, for the rams, and for the lambs, according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. On the eighth day you shall have a solemn assembly, you shall do no servile work, but you shall offer a burnt offering, an offering made by fire, of a pleasant aroma to the Lord, 1 bull, 1 ram, 7 male lambs a year old without blemish, their meal offering and their drink offerings for the bull, for the ram, and for the lambs, shall be according to their number, after the ordinance, and 1 male goat for a sin offering, besides the continual burnt offering, and the meal offering of it, and the drink offering of it. You shall offer these to the Lord in your set feasts, besides your vows, and your freewill offerings, for your burnt offerings, and for your meal offerings, and for your drink offerings, and for your peace offerings. Moses told the children of Israel according to all that the Lord commanded Moses. Chapter 30. Moses spoke to the heads of the tribes of the children of Israel, saying, "This is the thing which the Lord has commanded. When a man vows a vow to the Lord, or swears an oath to bind his soul with a bond, he shall not break his word, he shall do according to all that proceeds out of his mouth. Also when a woman vows a vow to the Lord, and binds herself by a bond, being in her father's house, in her youth, and her father hears her vow, and her bond with which she has bound her soul, and her father holds his peace at her, then all her vows shall stand, and every bond with which she has bound her soul shall stand. But if her father disallow her in the day that he hears, none of her vows, or of her bonds with which she has bound her soul, shall stand, and the Lord will forgive her, because her father disallowed her. If she has a husband, while her vows are on her, or the rash utterance of her lips, with which she has bound her soul, and her husband hears it, and holds his peace at her in the day that he hears it, then her vows shall stand, and her bonds with which she has bound her soul shall stand. But if her husband forbids her in the day that he hears it, then he shall make void her vow which is on her, and the rash utterance of her lips, with which she has bound her soul, and the Lord will forgive her. But the vow of a widow, or of her who is divorced, everything with which she has bound her soul, shall stand against her. If she vowed in her husband's house, or bound her soul by a bond with an oath, and her husband heard it, and held his peace at her, and did not disallow her, then all her vows shall stand, and every bond with which she bound her soul shall stand. But if her husband made them null and void in the day that he heard them, then whatever proceeded out of her lips concerning her vows, or concerning the bond of her soul, shall not stand, her husband has made them void, and the Lord will forgive her. Every vow, and every binding oath to afflict the soul, her husband may establish it, or her husband may make it void. But if her husband says nothing to her from day to day, then he establishes all her vows, or all her bonds, which are on her, he has established them, because he says nothing to her on the day that he heard them. But if he shall make them null and void after that he has heard them, then he shall bear her iniquity. These are the statutes, which the Lord commanded Moses, between a man and his wife, between a father and his daughter, being in her youth, in her father's house. Chapter 31. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Avenge the children of Israel for the Midianites. Afterward you shall be gathered to your people." Moses spoke to the people, saying, "Arm men from among you for the war, that they may go against Midian, to execute the Lord's vengeance on Midian. Of every tribe 1,000, throughout all the tribes of Israel, you shall send to the war." So there were delivered, out of the thousands of Israel, 1,000 of every tribe, 12,000 armed for war. Moses sent them, 1,000 of every tribe, to the war, them and Phinehas the son of Eleazar the priest, to the war, with the vessels of the sanctuary and the trumpets for the alarm in his hand. They warred against Midian, as the Lord commanded Moses, and they killed every male. They killed the kings of Midian with the rest of their slain, Evi, and Rechem, and Zur, and Hur, and Reba, the five kings of Midian. Balaam also the son of Beor they killed with the sword. The children of Israel took captive the women of Midian and their little ones, and all their livestock, and all their flocks, and all their goods, they took for a prey. All their cities and the places in which they lived, and all their encampments, they burnt with fire. They took all the spoil, and all the prey, both of man and of animal. They brought the captives, and the prey, and the spoil, to Moses, and to Eleazar the priest, and to the congregation of the children of Israel, to the camp at the plains of Moab, which are by the Jordan at Jericho. Moses, and Eleazar the priest, and all the leaders of the congregation, went forth to meet them outside of the camp. Moses was angry with the officers of the army, the captains of thousands and the captains of hundreds, who came from the service of the war. Moses said to them, "Have you saved all the women alive? Look, these caused the children of Israel, through the counsel of Balaam, to commit trespass against the Lord in the matter of Peor, and so the plague was among the congregation of the Lord. Now therefore kill every male among the little ones, and kill every woman who has known man by lying with him. But all the girls, who have not known man by lying with him, keep alive for yourselves. Encamp outside of the camp 7 days, whoever has killed any person, and whoever has touched any slain, purify yourselves on the 3rd day and on the 7th day, you and your captives. As to every garment, and all that is made of skin, and all work of goat's hair, and all things made of wood, you shall purify yourselves." Eleazar the priest said to the men of war who went to the battle, "This is the statute of the law which the Lord has commanded Moses: however the gold, and the silver, the bronze, the iron, the tin, and the lead, everything that may withstand the fire, you shall make to go through the fire, and it shall be clean. Nevertheless it shall be purified with the water for impurity, and all that doesn't withstand the fire you shall make to go through the water. You shall wash your clothes on the 7th day, and you shall be clean, and afterward you shall come into the camp." The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Take the sum of the prey that was taken, both of man and of animal, you, and Eleazar the priest, and the heads of the ancestral houses of the congregation, and divide the prey into 2 parts, between them and skilled in war, who went out to battle, and all the congregation. Levy a tribute to the Lord of the men of war who went out to battle, 1 soul of 500, of the persons, of the cattle, of the donkeys, and of the flocks. Take it of their half, and give it to Eleazar the priest, for the Lord's wave offering. Of the children of Israel's half, you shall take 1 drawn out of every 50, of the persons, of the cattle, of the donkeys, and of the flocks, of all the livestock, and give them to the Levites, who perform the duty of the tabernacle of the Lord." Moses and Eleazar the priest did as the Lord commanded Moses. Now the prey, over and above the booty which the men of war took, was 675,000 sheep, and 72,000 head of cattle, and 61,000 donkeys, and 32,000 persons in all, of the women who had not known man by lying with him. The half, which was the portion of those who went out to war, was in number 337,500 sheep, and the Lord's tribute of the sheep was 675. The cattle were 36,000, of which the Lord's tribute was 72. The donkeys were 30,500, of which the Lord's tribute was 61. The persons were 16,000, of whom the Lord's tribute was 32 persons. Moses gave the tribute, which was the Lord's wave offering, to Eleazar the priest, as the Lord commanded Moses. Of the children of Israel's half, which Moses divided off from the men who warred, now the congregation's half was 337,500 sheep, and 36,000 head of cattle, and 30,500 donkeys, and 16,000 persons, even of the children of Israel's half. Moses took 1 drawn out of every 50, both of man and of animal, and gave them to the Levites, who performed the duty of the tabernacle of the Lord, as the Lord commanded Moses. The officers who were over the thousands of the army, the captains of thousands, and the captains of hundreds, came near to Moses, and they said to Moses, "Your servants have taken the sum of the men of war who are under our command, and there lacks not one man of us. We have brought the Lord's offering, what every man has gotten, of jewels of gold, armlets, and bracelets, signet rings, earrings, and necklaces, to make atonement for our souls before the Lord." Moses and Eleazar the priest took their gold, even all work jewels. All the gold of the wave offering that they offered up to the Lord, of the captains of thousands, and of the captains of hundreds, was 16,750 shekels. The men of war had taken booty, every man for himself. Moses and Eleazar the priest took the gold of the captains of thousands and of hundreds, and brought it into the tent of meeting, for a memorial for the children of Israel before the Lord. Chapter 32. Now the children of Reuben and the children of Gad had a very great multitude of livestock, and when they saw the land of Yazer, and the land of Gilead, that look, the place was a place for livestock, the children of Gad and the children of Reuben came and spoke to Moses, and to Eleazar the priest, and to the leaders of the congregation, saying, Ataroth, and Dibon, and Yazer, and Nimrah, and Heshbon, and Eliela, and Sibma, and Nebo, and Beon, the land which the Lord struck before the congregation of Israel, is a land for livestock, and your servants have livestock. They said, If we have found favor in your sight, let this land be given to your servants for a possession, do not bring us over the Jordan. Moses said to the children of Gad, and to the children of Reuben, Shall your brothers go to the war, and shall you sit here? Why do you discourage the heart of the children of Israel from going over into the land which the Lord has given them? Your fathers did so when I sent them from Kadesh Barnea to see the land. For when they went up to the valley of Eshcol, and saw the land, they discouraged the heart of the children of Israel, that they should not go into the land which the Lord had given them. The Lord's anger was kindled in that day, and he swore, saying, Surely none of the men who came up out of Egypt, from 20 years old and upward, shall see the land which I swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, because they have not wholly followed me, except Caleb the son of Jephunneh the Kenzite, and Joshua the son of Nun, because they have followed the Lord completely. The Lord's anger was kindled against Israel, and he made them wander back and forth in the wilderness 40 years, until all the generation, who had done evil in the sight of the Lord, was consumed. Look, you have risen up in your father's place, an increase of sinful men, to augment yet the fierce anger of the Lord toward Israel. For if you turn away from after him, he will yet again leave them in the wilderness, and you will destroy all this people. They came near to him, and said, We will build sheepfolds here for our livestock, and cities for our little ones, but we ourselves will be ready armed to go before the children of Israel, until we have brought them to their place, and our little ones shall dwell in the fortified cities because of the inhabitants of the land. We will not return to our houses, until the children of Israel have inherited every man his inheritance. For we will not inherit with them on the other side of the Jordan, and forward, because our inheritance is fallen to us on this side of the Jordan eastward. Moses said to them, If you will do this thing, if you will arm yourselves to go before the Lord to the war, and every armed man of you will pass over the Jordan before the Lord, until he has driven out his enemies from before him, and the land is subdued before the Lord, then afterward you shall return, and be guiltless towards the Lord, and towards Israel, and this land shall be to you for a possession before the Lord. But if you will not do so, look, you have sinned against the Lord, and be sure your sin will find you out. Build cities for your little ones, and folds for your sheep, and do that which has proceeded out of your mouth. The children of Gad and the children of Reuben spoke to Moses, saying, Your servants will do as my Lord commands. Our little ones, our wives, our flocks, and all our livestock, shall be there in the cities of Gilead, but your servants will pass over, every man who is armed for war, before the Lord to battle, as my Lord says. So Moses commanded concerning them to Eleazar the priest, and to Joshua the son of Nun, and to the heads of the ancestral houses of the tribes of the children of Israel. Moses said to them, If the children of Gad and the children of Reuben will pass with you over the Jordan, every man who is armed to battle before the Lord, and the land is subdued before you, then you are to give them the land of Gilead for a possession. But if they will not pass over with you armed to battle before the Lord, then you are to bring over their children and their wives and their flocks before you into the land of Canaan, and they are to have possessions among you in the land of Canaan. The children of Gad and the children of Reuben answered, saying, As the Lord has said to your servants, so will we do. We will pass over armed before the Lord into the land of Canaan, and the possession of our inheritance shall remain with us beyond the Jordan. Moses gave to them, even to the children of Gad, and to the children of Reuben, and to the half-tribe of Manasseh the son of Joseph, the kingdom of Sihon king of the Amorites, and the kingdom of Og king of Bashan, the land, according to its cities and borders, even the cities of the surrounding land. The children of Gad built Dibon, and Ataroth, and Aroer, and Atroth-Shaphan, and Yazer, and Jogbah, and Beth-Nimrah, and Beth-Horon, fortified cities, and folds for sheep. The children of Reuben built Heshbon, and Elealeh, and Kiriathaim, and Nebo, and Baal-meon, their names being changed, and Sibmah, and they gave other names to the cities which they built. The children of Machir the son of Manasseh went to Gilead, and took it, and dispossessed the Amorites who were in it. Moses gave Gilead to Machir the son of Manasseh, and he lived in it. Yair the son of Manasseh went and took its towns, and called them Haoth-Yair. Noba went and took Kanath, and its villages, and called it Noba, after his own name. Chapter 33. These are the journeys of the children of Israel, when they went forth out of the land of Egypt by their armies under the hand of Moses and Aaron. Moses wrote their goings out according to their journeys by the commandment of the Lord, and these are their journeys according to their goings out. They traveled from Ramesses in the first month, on the 15th day of the first month, on the next day after the Passover. The children of Israel went out triumphantly in the sight of all the Egyptians, while the Egyptians were burying all their firstborn, whom the Lord had struck among them. On their gods also the Lord executed judgments. The children of Israel traveled from Ramesses, and camped in Succoth. They traveled from Succoth, and camped in Etham, which is in the edge of the wilderness. They traveled from Etham, and turned back to Pihahiroth, which is before Baal Zephon, and they camped before Migdal. They traveled from before Haaroth, and passed through the midst of the sea into the wilderness, and they went 3 days' journey in the wilderness of Etham, and camped in Marah. They traveled from Marah, and came to Elim, and in Elim were 12 springs of water, and 70 palm trees, and they camped there. They traveled from Elim, and camped by the Sea of Suf. They traveled from the Sea of Suf, and camped in the wilderness of Sin. They traveled from the wilderness of Sin, and camped in Dophka. They traveled from Dophka, and camped in Elush. They traveled from Elush, and camped in Rephidim, where there was no water for the people to drink. They traveled from Rephidim, and camped in the wilderness of Sinai. They traveled from the wilderness of Sinai, and camped in Kibroth Hattaava. They traveled from Kibroth Hattaava, and camped in Hazeroth. They traveled from Hazeroth, and camped in Rithmah. They traveled from Rithmah, and camped in Rimmon Perez. They traveled from Rimmon Perez, and camped in Libna. They traveled from Libna, and camped in Rissa. They traveled from Rissa, and camped in Kohelitha. They traveled from Kohelitha, and camped in Mount Shepher. They traveled from Mount Shepher, and camped in Haradah. They traveled from Haradah, and camped in Makaloth. They traveled from Makaloth, and camped in Tihat. They traveled from Tihat, and camped in Terah. They traveled from Terah, and camped in Mithka. They traveled from Mithka, and camped in Hashmana. They traveled from Hashmana, and camped in Moseroth. They traveled from Moseroth, and camped in Beni Jaakon. They traveled from Beni Jaakon, and camped in Hor-Haggidgad. They traveled from Hor-Haggidgad, and camped in Jotbathah. They traveled from Jotbathah, and camped in Abrona. They traveled from Abrona, and camped in Ezion Geber. They traveled from Ezion Geber, and camped in the wilderness of Zin, that is, Kadesh. They traveled from Kadesh, and camped in Mount Hor, in the edge of the land of Edom. Aaron the priest went up into Mount Hor at the commandment of the Lord, and died there, in the 40th year after the children of Israel had come out of the land of Egypt, in the 5th month, on the first day of the month. Aaron was 123 years old when he died in Mount Hor. The Canaanite, the king of Arad, who lived in the Negev in the land of Canaan, heard of the coming of the children of Israel. They traveled from Mount Hor, and camped in Zalmona. They traveled from Zalmona, and camped in Punon. They traveled from Punon, and camped in Oboth. They traveled from Oboth, and camped in Iabarim, in the border of Moab. They traveled from Eam, and camped in Dibon Gad. They traveled from Dibon Gad, and camped in Almon Diblathaim. They traveled from Almon Diblathaim, and camped in the mountains of Abarim, before Nebo. They traveled from the mountains of Abarim, and camped in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho. They camped by the Jordan, from Beth Jeshimot even to Abel Shittim in the plains of Moab. The Lord spoke to Moses in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho, saying, "Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, when you pass over the Jordan into the land of Canaan, then you shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you, destroy all their stone idols, destroy all their molten images, and demolish all their high places. You shall take possession of the land, and dwell in it, for I have given the land to you to possess it. You shall inherit the land by lot according to your families, to the more you shall give the more inheritance, And to the fewer you shall give the less inheritance, wherever the lot falls to any man, that shall be his. You shall inherit according to the tribes of your fathers. But if you do not drive out the inhabitants of the land from before you, then those you let remain of them will be as pricks in your eyes and as thorns in your sides, and they will harass you in the land in which you dwell. It shall happen that as I thought to do to them, so will I do to you. Chapter 34. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Command the children of Israel, and tell them, When you come into the land of Canaan, this is the land that shall fall to you for an inheritance, even the land of Canaan according to its borders, then your south quarter shall be from the wilderness of Zin along by the side of Edom, and your south border shall be from the end of the Salt Sea eastward, and your border shall turn about southward of the ascent of Ekrabim, and pass along to Zin, and the goings out of it shall be southward of Kadesh Barnea, and it shall go forth to Hazer Adar, and pass along to Asmon, and the border shall turn about from Asmon to the Wadi of Egypt, and the goings out of it shall be at the sea. For the western border, the great sea shall be a border to you, this shall be your west border. This shall be your north border, from the great sea you shall mark out for you Mount Hor, from Mount Hor you shall mark out to Lebo Hamath, and the goings out of the border shall be at Zadad, and the border shall go forth to Ziphron, and the goings out of it shall be at Hazer Enon. This shall be your north border. You shall mark out your east border from Hazer Enon to Shepham, and the border shall go down from Shepham to Riblah, on the east side of Ain, and the border shall go down, and shall reach to the side of the Sea of Kinnereth eastward, and the border shall go down to the Jordan, and the goings out of it shall be at the Salt Sea. This shall be your land according to its borders around it. Moses commanded the children of Israel, saying, This is the land which you shall inherit by lot, which the Lord has commanded to give to the nine tribes, and to the half-tribe, for the tribe of the children of Reuben according to their fathers' houses, and the tribe of the children of Gad according to their fathers' houses, have received, and the half-tribe of Manasseh have received, their inheritance, the two tribes and the half-tribe have received their inheritance beyond the Jordan at Jericho eastward, toward the sunrise. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, These are the names of the men who shall divide the land to you for inheritance, Eleazar the priest, and Joshua the son of Nun. You shall take one prince of every tribe, to divide the land for inheritance. These are the names of the men, of the tribe of Judah, Caleb the son of Jephunneh. Of the tribe of the children of Simeon, Shemuel the son of Ammihud. Of the tribe of Benjamin, Elidad the son of Chislon. Of the tribe of the children of Dan a prince, Bukai the son of Yogli. Of the children of Joseph, of the tribe of the children of Manasseh a prince, Haniel the son of Ephod. Of the tribe of the children of Ephraim a prince, Kemuel the son of Shiftan. Of the tribe of the children of Zebulun a prince, Elizaphan the son of Parnak. Of the tribe of the children of Issachar a prince, Paltiel the son of Azan. Of the tribe of the children of Asher a prince, Ahihud the son of Shelemi. Of the tribe of the children of Naphtali a prince, Petahel the son of Ammihud. These are they whom the Lord commanded to divide the inheritance to the children of Israel in the land of Canaan. Chapter 35. The Lord spoke to Moses in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho, saying, Command the children of Israel that they give to the Levites of the inheritance of their possession cities to dwell in, and you shall give suburbs for the cities around them to the Levites. The cities shall they have to dwell in, and their suburbs shall be for their livestock, and for their substance, and for all their animals. The suburbs of the cities, which you shall give to the Levites, shall be from the wall of the city and outward 1,722 feet 6 inches around it. You shall measure outside of the city for the east side 3,445 feet, and for the south side 3,445 feet, and for the west side 3,445 feet, and for the north side 3,445 feet, the city being in the midst. This shall be to them the suburbs of the cities. The cities which you shall give to the Levites, they shall be the six cities of refuge, which you shall give for the manslayer to flee to, and besides them you shall give 42 cities. All the cities which you shall give to the Levites shall be 48 cities together with their suburbs. Concerning the cities which you shall give of a possession of the children of Israel, from the many you shall take many, and from the few you shall take few, everyone according to his inheritance which he inherits shall give of his cities to the Levites. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the children of Israel, and tell them, When you pass over the Jordan into the land of Canaan, then you shall appoint you cities to be cities of refuge for you, that the manslayer who kills any person unwittingly may flee there. The city shall be to you for refuge from the avenger, that the manslayer not die, until he stands before the congregation for judgment. The cities which you shall give shall be for you six cities of refuge. You shall give three cities beyond the Jordan, and you shall give three cities in the land of Canaan, they shall be cities of refuge. For the children of Israel, and for the stranger and for the foreigner living among them, shall these six cities be for refuge, that everyone who kills any person unwittingly may flee there. But if he struck him with an instrument of iron, so that he died, he is a murderer, the murderer shall surely be put to death. If he struck him with a stone in the hand, by which a man may die, and he died, he is a murderer, the murderer shall surely be put to death. Or if he struck him with a weapon of wood in the hand, by which a man may die, and he died, he is a murderer, the murderer shall surely be put to death. The avenger of blood shall himself put the murderer to death, when he meets him, he shall put him to death. If he thrust him of hatred, or hurled at him, lying in wait, so that he died, or in enmity struck him with his hand, so that he died, he who struck him shall surely be put to death. He is a murderer, the murderer must surely be put to death, the avenger of blood shall put the murderer to death when he meets him. But if he thrust him suddenly without enmity, or hurled on him anything without lying in wait, or with any stone, by which a man may die, not seeing him, and cast it on him, so that he died, and he was not his enemy, neither saw it his harm, then the congregation shall judge between the striker and the avenger of blood according to these ordinances, and the congregation shall deliver the manslayer out of the hand of the avenger of blood, and the congregation shall restore him to his city of refuge, where he was fled, and he shall dwell in it until the death of the high priest, who was anointed with the holy oil. But if the manslayer shall at any time go beyond the border of his city of refuge, where he flees, and the avenger of blood find him outside of the border of his city of refuge, and the avenger of blood kill the manslayer, he shall not be guilty of blood, because he should have remained in his city of refuge until the death of the high priest. But after the death of the high priest the manslayer shall return into the land of his possession. These things shall be for a statute and ordinance to you throughout your generations in all your dwellings. Whoever kills any person, the murderer shall be slain at the mouth of witnesses, but one witness shall not testify against any person that he die. Moreover, you shall take no ransom for the life of a murderer who is guilty of death, but he shall surely be put to death. You shall take no ransom for him who is fled to his city of refuge, that he may come again to dwell in the land, until the death of the priest. So you shall not pollute the land in which you are, for blood, it pollutes the land, and no expiation can be made for the land for the blood that is shed in it, but by the blood of him who shed it. You shall not defile the land which you inhabit, in the midst of which I dwell, for I, the Lord, dwell in the midst of the children of Israel. Chapter 36. The heads of the ancestral houses of the family of the children of Gilead, the son of Machir, the son of Manasseh, of the families of the sons of Joseph, came near and spoke before Moses and before Eleazar the priest and before the leaders, the heads of the ancestral houses of the children of Israel. And they said, "The Lord commanded my Lord to give the land for inheritance by lot to the children of Israel, and my Lord was commanded by the Lord to give the inheritance of Zelophehad our brother to his daughters. If they are married to any of the sons of the other tribes of the children of Israel, then will their inheritance be taken away from the inheritance of our fathers, and will be added to the inheritance of the tribe whereunto they shall belong, so will it be taken away from the lot of our inheritance. When the jubilee of the children of Israel shall be, then will their inheritance be added to the inheritance of the tribe whereunto they shall belong, so will their inheritance be taken away from the inheritance of the tribe of our fathers." Moses commanded the children of Israel according to the word of the Lord, saying, "The tribe of the sons of Joseph speaks right. This is the thing which the Lord does command concerning the daughters of Zelophehad, saying, Let them be married to whom they think best, only into the family of the tribe of their father shall they be married. So shall no inheritance of the children of Israel remove from tribe to tribe, for the children of Israel shall all keep the inheritance of the tribe of his fathers. Every daughter who possesses an inheritance in any tribe of the children of Israel shall be wife to one of the family of the tribe of her father, that the children of Israel may possess every man the inheritance of his fathers. So shall no inheritance remove from one tribe to another tribe, for the tribes of the children of Israel shall each keep his own inheritance." The daughters of Zelophehad did as the Lord commanded Moses, for Mahlah, Tirzah, and Hoglah, and Milcah, and Noah, the daughters of Zelophehad, were married to their father's brother's sons. They were married into the families of the sons of Manasseh the son of Joseph, and their inheritance remained in the tribe of the family of their father. These are the commandments and the ordinances which the Lord commanded by Moses to the children of Israel in the plains of Moab by the Jordan at Jericho.